The 2015 AFL season hasn't begun in the way which Port Adelaide would have wanted. 0-2. Suddenly the balance between expectation and results is out of whack. It's a pressure welcomed by Ken Hinckley. However, this kind of pressure is new, having only exceeded the hopes of power fans since taking over the reins. Expectation. It's also the buzzword for the Arden Street elite. Woeful one week, brilliant the next.
Trelaw on the sire and he's got it!
Wolves boss Brad Scott has been damning at the side's lack of consistency. For two teams with top four aspirations, tonight is crunch time.
It's bending back. That is a beautiful kick.
The Roos and power at Etihad Stadium. This is Saturday Night Footy.
A very good evening and welcome.
Trav, you caught it in the air, mate.
It's cool.
It's ahead.
North and Port, and you can only think that Port are fired up and ready to go on the back of their two losses this year. We know that they're going to figure at the end of the year. Richo, Darcy, Lingy, it's just a matter of when they get that started.
Absolutely, and they want it to be tonight. They have got a tough few weeks, we know that. They've got Hawthorn and then Adelaide to come. They've got to get a win tonight. North, they want to prove that they're the real deal this year. They believe they're a top four side. They finished in the top four last year. This is going to be a real test tonight. Two fast teams. It's going to be an exciting game.
Lingy, I know you spoke with Ken Hinckley not that long ago. What's the feel from a Port Adelaide perspective? They've got three of the top four sides in their first month. They've lost two already. How are they feeling about tonight?
Well, BT, his biggest thing was, I asked him the question, does the zero in the win column start to play with the players' heads a little bit? And he said, yes, naturally it does, but they have to force that out of their minds because they can't control that. All they can control is the type of footy that they go out and play tonight, and in particular, the first 5 or 10 minutes. And he said it was all about the contest. Get in there, have a crack, win the contested ball, put pressure on the opposition. He thought Sydney beat them in that area last week. He certainly doesn't want that to happen this week against North Melbourne.
Yeah, I think it's a natural thing, isn't it, Lee? To start with a little bit of doubt, you expect this year to be good. I thought they played a great game against Fremantle Dockers in round one. And then the Swans, they just had worked them out. They were really good at defending, as Lingy said. So that little man inside your head, he starts talking, thinking, are we capable of running over the top of sides like we did last year? This is going to be a cracker tonight. High-paced, fast game tonight. Really looking forward to it.
We get ready to go. All the big names are there. Daniel Wells, a late withdrawal. I think many expected that tonight. Jacobs comes into the side and is the sub for North. We're ready to go. Round three, North and Port. Etihad Stadium. Ryder with a big leap. Wines off his knee now. Collects it cleanly at ground level. Little ball out wide. Pollock is able to mark. What about the little one in back inside? And he finds the 150 game man, Ebert. Nice kick from him to Broadbent. Broadbent goes long and deep. Gray's got a bit of space between he and Cunnington.
Great start for Port Adelaide. They started with a 5-man forward line, 7-man defence. They've tried to open up their forward line. They had over 60 inside 50s last week.
Great plays. I'm not sure about the wisdom in that, especially considering it was to a more severe angle. And he would have been better from where he was.
Yeah, I'm surprised he didn't go back and have a shot. Robbie Gray, we know how good he is. He's a goal kicker. He would normally go back and have a shot there.
And he was the one, guys, who started in the centre bounce, just charged forward to make it a 6-man forward line in the end. So would have loved to start with a goal.
Wingard along the ground, dribbling in the right direction. Always dangerous from there.
This is a good sign, though. Gray's in the game early. Wingard's in the game early. So the gun's getting a touch in the forward 50.
Yeah, and some space inside 50 for Port Adelaide, something they didn't get a lot of last week. Boomer Harvey, the kick-in duties, played a fair bit of halfback in their big win over the Brisbane Lions. So this is the captain, Swallow. Going to work his way along the boundary line. Big Drew Petrie comes out. Takes a nice mark in front of Alec Paddy Carlisle. Gibson, prolific ball winner. Dangerous ball to Nahas. Over the top. Spore was effective there from Jonas. They got some numbers back here at centre-half. Back to power. Pittard likes to get back onto his left. Polak, P2. And that's going to be broken up. And the little boomer's got hold of it. 70 out.
And he never wastes any time going, and he's looking for Big Ben Brown. Ella Paddy Carlisle, and Ryder was there with the thump away as well. Now Boat just tidies up, so just under a little bit of pressure of their own here at the moment. Monfrey's come a long way down the field.
You can already see North Melbourne's intent to play on, wheel around and get the ball moving quickly.
Surely, Dash, North would have looked at how Sydney did it last week and gave them very little space and try and adopt the same policy. We're not capable of it.
No doubt that everyone has gone to school on Port Adelaide and this specific hard-running game they play. The trouble is, can you execute it the way the Swans did?
Schultz, was it a nudge? No, umpire says good. Now, he can kick it from there. I'm not sure why he didn't go back. Here's the thumping kick of the footy. Jonas, now Wines. Wines, a bullet ball inside 50. Missed Gray, well and truly over the head.
Missed a massive opportunity. Wingard and Westhoff were free inside 50. Schultz kicks into the man on the mark.
McDonald's kick no good. Broadbent, a lot of skill errors by foot being made here at the moment. Nice work on the footy there to Boak. Boak back to Broadbent, had to stretch. Now he can settle. He could have taken another couple of steps and that's hit the behind post, or in fact it is a behind.
Gidlingi, there's some pace on this early.
Yeah, absolutely, Richo. Both teams really looking to play on at every opportunity. They both love the high-paced game. They're also high-paced in defence, both of these teams. Attlee takes off straight away, but in some trouble now.
He's had a meltdown there, Sean Attlee. He just ran into a big hole at Etihad Stadium and a turnover the way of Port Adelaide.
Yeah, the intent is to play on, though. Port have taken 9 marks, played on 7 times. Both teams want to move it quickly.
You get a good look at what Matty Broadbent has on offer. Has to chip it into a dangerous spot. Numbers back. We know Scotty Thompson likes to get third man in. Here he is. Got a couple of heavy knocks last week, but good to see him back out there. At the moment, though, it's Port who are controlling the footy. They're going to transfer play through Trengove and Ella Paddy's got hold of the footy now. Short one on to Weebit. Game 150 for that man. They'll get it moving again, pushing up the ground. Jonas, he's got one he likes. And Matty White, the hard-running former Tiger, has got free. And they're finding a bit of space, Richo, early, which will give them a bit of confidence.
Yeah, they certainly are dominating possession. That's their 14th mark already, so a really good start. But you have to hit the scoreboard. There's no point getting your hands on it, getting an inside 50 if you're not scoring.
Kicked a career high, 25 goals last year for the Power to this man, Matty White. They'd like a nice settler here. White strikes it nicely. Has it got the accuracy? Matty White kicks the first of the night for the Power.
Got through that really nicely, enjoyed it off the boot.
There he is, the white zone.
Yep, and the cheer squad here in big numbers for Port Adelaide, thoroughly enjoying themselves and saluting as that one went through. Umpires tonight, by the way, Chris Donald, Luke Farmer, and that man Brendan Hosking throwing the ball up. Wines has been in the thick of it in the centre clearances so far. This one's not coming out, I don't think. Good crowd in. You can see the North Melbourne supporters in the background there.
So we have a loose player back at each end.
Will that continue, Richo?
I think it will. I think it will.
Jonas. Wingard had it knocked away by Tarrant. Hands of McDonald were swatted down. Now an opportunity for White for number two. Needs a good bounce. It didn't quite do what he thought it would do. Monfries is clever. He goes backwards looking for Polak and in the end kicked it straight down the throat of Wood.
The man that was loose at that centre bounce for Port Adelaide is Cracker, BT. Hasn't played a game for over 1,400 days.
Yeah, wow.
It's good to see him back, isn't it?
He's a great story, Richo. Look at the pressure from the Power. They are applying a bit of Swans-like action from last week. Sean Higgins, the former Dog, has to work his way through it. Made a nice start to his career at the Kangaroos. He'd be pretty happy with that. Managed to keep it in, and they'll reset. He looks fit, Sean Higgins. Averaging 3 goals a game in his first 2 games in the Kangaroos strip. Here's Goldstein, has to be the informed big man in the competition. Some hands there. It's Kane Mitchell back in the team. Now an opportunity via Robbie Gray. The numbers are back there, and it will be right to clean it up.
You're going to have to lower your eyes tonight. If this loose player's back at either end, you've got to try and hit a target. A long kick probably isn't going to work.
Becoming a reliable player, Sam Wright, for North. And edging up towards his 100 games, game 87 for him tonight. There's Mitchell, who Das spoke of, back into the side for Port.
Yeah,
free kick.
Lindsay Thomas.
This next kick's an important one for North Melbourne, though. They haven't been able to get it much past this area of the ground. They've only had the one inside 50 so far in this game, and they've just got nowhere, and it's been slow each time because Port Adelaide are defending so well and forcing that long kick.
Thomas, a high ball on the head of Brown. Now Bastanacki's corralled and cornered, and real desperation pressure stuff, as the boys have already mentioned here from Port. North Melbourne coming off that thumping last week. The Lions 82 points, and of course Port off their loss to the Swans by 48. Wade kicking 7 goals last week. What's he got tonight? So Weston been criticised for his inconsistency at Carlton, Richo.
Yeah, it has been something people have talked about. Well, Benny Brown, he hits up, he works hard, he'll be disappointed there.
Related to the Manson family down there in Tassie, Benny Brown.
His mum used to teach me at school in Devonport.
Really?
Benny Brown's mum. That's in Brendan's.
Yeah. Want to say hello to her?
Yeah, g'day, Mrs. Brown.
Oh, you're kidding.
I wasn't the greatest student, right?
Cracker. Back into traffic, had to go. Now he's got his head over this one. Here is Waite. Little handball. Thomas is good on his left. Swings it around. He's a real cool customer. Thomas goals.
Right against the flow of play, this one. Port Adelaide have dominated possession. They've had a lot more of the footy in their forward half of the ground, but that will be a nice confidence boost to Richo for the Kangaroos.
Yeah, only their second inside 50, North Melbourne, 7 to Port Adelaide.
Isn't the best of bounces. It bounced over the head of Goldstein, umpire said play on. Swallow got in low and hard. Montfries did really well. Now the athleticism of Ryder on display. He wants Westhoff. Did pretty well, Robbie Tarrant. Back into the side, just played the one game of footy last year. Robbie Tarrant had a really rare nerve-related leg injury. Port get it again. Broadbent's got a man free. Montfries started in the centre. He drifted forward. And Angus has found some space. He's a goal kicker, Richo. He should go back and score from here.
Yeah, he should. And that's twice that's happened now. Robbie Gray ran back into space, took a mark. So did Matty White. So these half-forwards, smaller forwards for Port Adelaide have been able to run back in and find space early.
Tough kick for him, though, Darcy. He's a right-to-left bender of the footy, so he's got to aim at the right goalpost, and that'll be tough.
We'll get a great look at it here. Angus Montfries, 39 goals in 2013, back to just 21 last year, and he'll be disappointed in that. Started at right, BT all over it. Couldn't get it going the way he wanted to and through for a minor score.
Hey, guys, you've picked that one really well out of the centre bounce. At Port Adelaide now, 3 or 4 times, have just used a forward up in the middle part of the ground, either at a centre bounce or a stoppage, who is just charging forward a million miles an hour and is getting on the end of those. It was Montfries then. He started it and just ended up with the shot goal.
That was a full-on, well-organised press that North almost got through. It crumbled at centre-half back, but boy, were they all switched on as individuals to form that great team defence? Pollack short, finds Pittard.
Once you break through, you normally score, so I'd be disappointed there, North.
It was a clamping look. Get a high look at that next time they set it up. Westhoff. Goes very, very wide. Homps is there. He didn't really want to know about it. He said to Jonas, yours. And Jonas said, no, yours. Here's Mitchell. One of the fittest players at the club. Good-looking ball into Ebutton. He marks just within his range, I reckon.
Well, they're finding a lot more space than they could find last week against Sydney.
Yeah.
Sydney just choked them in there. The ball kept going in. Sydney just kept rebounding the footy, but already tonight they're finding space.
Yeah, they feel really good about this at the moment, Richo. They're all getting plenty of the footy and they're having shots on goal and at goal like that. And Ebutton, game 150, gets his first.
Have a look at this. This is a great set shot at goal, and he deserved that. He worked so hard to run and get into space to give his teammates an option. And Ken Hinckley talked about his two-way run this week.
Expecting a real play-on, fast-flowing game, but it's all one way at the moment.
There we go.
In terms of ball movement, Westhoff had a good look at that. He'll be disappointed. Ryder did well out of the centre bounce. The Kangaroos trying to burst out of half-back. Boomer Harvey playing at half-back at the moment. They've got to go down the line. Alec Paddy Carlisle, he got rid of the body of Petrie, swings it back into Ebert. He started with a heap of the footy. Possession number 6 for that man. Ollie Wines, Ebert
crashed into him. Broadbent's had a lot of the footy onto Boak, and they have got more space than they've found in recent times here, the power.
They're loving it, Das. Broadbent around the corner, has Wines again.
Well, their movement's been great. Every player is on the move.
I'm going to ask Lingy a question in a moment. It seems to be more about composure for North than competing at the moment. I think they're competing well, Lingy, but it's just about when they get hold of the footy and how they find their way through.
They are, BT, you're spot on there. It's that kick to centre-half forward. They just keep turning it over. They've been getting this kick all night, but the next one's really been hard for them. They haven't been able to move it quickly and fluently from here, and it's cost them. They keep giving it back to Port Adelaide. Much better, though, hit up to Jared Waite.
Jack Zeeble winded there in the bottom of your screens, and he's just drawn the big ones in. Going to come to the bench and perhaps regain his composure. Not sure, Lingy, whether it could be something a little more internal.
Well, it was a pretty big clash between Jack Zeeble and, he's
the
in the world.
The blood has been activated here, so...
Yep, this is the clash with Ollie Wines and Jack Zeeble. Two really tough, hard players, but... unfortunately, Jack Zeeble is not in a good way at all, as you can see bottom of your screen there. That was a hard hit.
Gibson, in the meantime, goes inside. In front was Young. Alapati Carlisle tidies up now. Pittard, he's told to go and run and take him on. He does. He ran into a bit of a brick wall. Wines has been in everything. There's an opportunity for Boak. He's bootless. As over the line we go. Throw in, centre wing here.
Saw Pittard there. He tries to take the game on from half back. He's had a fantastic start to the year. And Ken Hinckley will keep encouraging him to do that. You need your half backs running and creating.
Got to love the approach here from the power tonight. Under pressure, they've lost their first two games. And Ken Hinckley said, you know what, we'll go harder. We'll play on quicker. We'll get our midfielders pushing harder forward. And they've really got a bit of momentum here. Can the Kangaroos get back, Robbie? Tarrant with the footy. It's a good ball. Wright might be able to run onto it. Coming another way. Carlisle, big collision coming. And Wright, well, he hasn't moved right. Picking the footy up is Bastanac. It felt like a fair bump.
That was a big play by Carlisle.
He has not moved.
Hasn't got off the ground at all. We'll come back to that shortly. Kane Turner, the little man. Did he keep it in? Well, you could see it coming. From our vantage point here, it was courageous from both players, Richo, and the end result is that man there is still on the ground.
Well, Carlisle had to make a judgment call. He had to come at the footy. And just a clash as they go for the ball, and Carlisle's a big man.
Good, honest clash it was, Richo.
If Carlisle didn't come off his own man then, Wright would have ran onto the footy and run through 50.
Oh, look, they're both absolutely committed to win the footy. Courage, ferocity there, great. Wines again. Ebert held out of the play there. Opportunity for him to crash through. Brown with a little poker. Hartlett's in there. So is Young. Spun on the tackle. The dangerous Thomas. Polak got him in a bear hugging tackle. And there is Wright. What do you think, Lingy?
It looks very similar to Jack Zeeble. It doesn't look good. You can just see the hit there. Hopefully his head's okay and it's more of a body clash, but do you worry when the head whiplashes like that? Great tackle. Port Adelaide's pressure has been outstanding so far in this first quarter. Jack Zeeble, of course, is also down the race. He's getting checked out. His one looked a lot nastier. He was coughing up blood as he was coming off the ground and standing on the bench. And, of course, he had a concussion during the pre-season as well, so getting it closely checked out.
This is a really fierce contest here at the moment. Make no mistake, it's fast and fierce. Here's White. Talking of the fast, he and Harvey together, all he could do was into down the line, couldn't keep it in.
Well, that's
one end of the other.
That's their plays. Matty White playing at half forward, comes right up the ground. He loves that fast break going back. Sam Wright, he looks okay there. They need to get him up and going. Zeeble in the rooms. You can't have two men down.
Just quickly, certainly the concussion sub, if not the sub, has been made for North Melbourne. Ben Jacobs about to come on. Jack Zeeble, the one who's out.
Okay, 20 minutes, Lingy.
I would think so, but I will double-check to see if it's not just a full sub that's been made as opposed to the concussion sub.
Yeah, nice work down there, Cameron Link, all over it. Feel like they've made a big statement here in the first 18 minutes. The power, they've been aggressive, they've been hard, and now... it's the Kangaroos' opportunity to respond. They're just going to hold on to possession here momentarily. Petrie's pushed all the way to half-back, and that's a nice ball. Broad, he finds Kate Turner.
The game's too fast at the moment. If it stays like this, I think North...
Gibson has got hold of the footy to Wade through his fingers. Look at the recovery from Wade. He kicked 7 last week. Jared Wade, 15 metres out. He's missed by 30 metres.
Oh, just got the wrong side of the footy there.
That is an opportunity that he'd like to have again, Jared Wade. Look at the reaction from the cheer squad behind the goals. They can't believe it.
Such a bad miss. It was as if he was kicking the wrong way. Terrible miss. Went with the right foot. Nana has Monfries working all parts of the ground. Hot pace of a game for Rito in really good position with Schultz. Huntington extracts. Brings it back, pops it into the danger zone. Here comes Wade again, committed. So was Homps, I think, went with him. Now Cracker, through some traffic. Nice and cool, straight down the middle. White's got to go now, and he does. Harvey was always there with him. It was well done. Thompson, just the stiff arm. That was nice. Swallow wide. North, an opportunity through Nahas. Nahas lets it rip with the bounce. Back inside. Now Thompson. Atlee it is, in fact. And you can see Port Adelaide player in trouble there as well. As Atlee goes inside to Thomas. Off hands. Cunnington, punch away Polak. Cracker again. Can he find the target this time? Once again, he puts it out in front of Westhoff. What can he do? Needs to keep it rolling to his end. He's turned it round and brought it back the other way. Wines cracks in. The pace is hot. This is unbelievable. Surely it's not sustainable.
What about the running machines on display at the moment? Mitchell's kicked forward. Swallow, they're gasping for air at the moment. Had a couple of fumbles. Well, he might have been happy to have a boundary thrown. Let's get down to the Lingy. What can you tell us?
Oh, so much happening at the moment. Tom Jonas, it is, getting his jaw checked out just from that contact with Jared Wade. Fair, hard marking contest. There is running galore in this game. There are contests galore. Great start to this game of footy.
Number one and two mark play on teams in the competition on display. Lingy, they love Richo as well, just to take the game on. And I feel like Port have had the commanding possession and the dominant play, but North, no problems really as yet on the scoreboard.
Well, I think Port would be happy with the game and how it's being played at the moment. They love this fast footy and the fast break that they are getting.
Doctors can't keep up with the carnage here. Mitchell over the top.
That's the thing with the pace of the game. When players hit each other now, they stay hit, and that's why North have got two players off, and now Jonas has come to the bench.
So just a rare moment for players to be able to collect themselves. Goldstein free. Paddy Ryder says, why? Goldstein just backwards to Thompson. Now McDonald. He knew all the time that the sub Jacobs was there. We think that he's on just for the concussion of Zeeble.
50.
Yep, once he got rid of the ball, 50 metres off the ball there. So it'll have to be at least the length of the square. And that's quite correct, umpire. Mitchell saying he marked it there, but...
Here, 50 metres, holding off the ball.
There you go. Succinct explanation of what's happening. Gibson. Deep. Wade underneath it. Brown second in line to have a go here. And boundary line beats all comers.
See if North Melbourne can just lock it inside 50 here for a couple of moments now. Take a little bit of pace out of it for a bit.
See a lot of numbers around the contest. Keep your eye on Bastanac, Swallow, Lindsay Thomas. We're desperate to get free. Through the hands of Pittard. Ollie Wines loves a contested footy. Broadbent working hard. Young Mason Wood involved as well. Young for Port Adelaide picked up by Swallow. Benny Jacobs, a late inclusion. Couldn't pick it up. Now the race is on. Wingard hasn't really been sighted so far in this one. McDonald cleaned it up. Got some support from Tarrant. And now this is Jacobs, handball partially smothered. Robbie Tarrant is going to try and burst through a couple. Did pretty well in the end to get in the Harvey direction. Playing genuine halfback to start this game. Jacobs, Ollie Wines got hold of him, Petrie. And now a little bit of an opportunity here for Ebert.
Ebert just out wide. They've tried this time and time again over the top. This time they've got a man with wheels. White wants to turn his man inside out. Went the low balls, Monfries. He needs help. He was one against four. He goes back to White. Swallow committed the body over the ball. Brilliant play by Swallow. Great leadership. And now an opportunity wide for Kane Turner. Turner at halfback.
It's going to be some cooked boys at quarter time. This
is
unbelievable.
You're going to say, Richo, before, who wins it if it stays at this pace?
Oh, I think this is what Port would like, but we know North Melbourne love playing on fast footy as well.
Looking very capable with a fast style at the moment. Here's Brown. Gray committed, Brown, beautiful little tap out. Nahas tried to winch the ball forward. Ryder ran past it. Wade not sure what to do. An opportunity now with Ebert. Thomas got him high. Free to Port Adelaide in defence. Brad Ebert.
One quick update on the bit of carnage. Tom Jonas is back out on the ground for Port Adelaide. He's okay and good to go.
See Broadbent now take a couple of bounces. Like the team that can use the footy under pressure the best is going to get the advantage. That wasn't Broadbent's finest kick. It's going to come back with a bit of interest. The Kangaroos who found the heat. A bit of an issue. Wingard run down from behind. Tackle was a great effort. Got hold of McDonald. Now that will please Chad Wingard. Great defensive tackle. Robbie Gray, he's an expert at getting around opponents. Looks up. There's not a lot that he likes initially. Happy just to kick it to space. And they're getting some numbers back. Could keep it in, BT.
Players are coming to the bench and asking to come off for Port Adelaide, and there is no one to go on that is ready to go on. So exhausting it's been.
Yeah, well, we know they rotate often, but they haven't got enough time to recover at the moment, the pace of this game.
They're being sent back to play. Such is the pace of this one. Through the middle again, another attack. Bastanac wanted to draw the player, and he did it really well. Now Gibson, a little poker, and Brown marks within Brown range.
Yeah, well done. There's absolutely no positional play here at all at the moment. It's just fast break from one end to the other.
And everyone was yelling at Ben Brown from North Melbourne then, just go back and have a shot because we need a rest.
Yeah.
Take some pace off this game.
And just a bit of composure there, Lee, I like from Gibson. He's had a massive quarter, 13 possessions, but if you can have composure by foot, you're in front.
A very high salute of the ball there, Ben Brown. He lines up, no angle to speak of. We'll have to kick at 50, though, and he's got all of that. Now it's about the accuracy, and he's got that as well. So North doing really well against a fierce Port Adelaide.
Great finish by Big Ben Brown, kicking right through it. Quick update on the sub for North Melbourne. It is the full sub. Jack Zeeble subbed out of the game. Ben Jacobs will stay in, so not the concussion.
Wow, it's a very quick thing. Follow that up, Lingy. That may well be a really obvious one then, given that decision. Here they go again. Opportunity. Free kick will go the way of Port Adelaide here, I think, will it?
Monfries, is it?
Yep. It is. Scotty Thompson can't believe it.
Angus Monfrey now.
Shiz. Look at Scotty Thompson. He is perplexed by this decision. We'll come back to the Jack Zeeble story. That is a big story. We know he's had a concussion already this year. But let's have a look at this replay, because Scotty Thompson is absolutely bemused by it. I think they're saying high contact off the footy.
Oh, I'm not sure about that.
So Monfries, as a result of all of that, here he is, directly in front. That's a good kick for him. So three to Port, two to North.
I think that's a bit of a gift.
Well, let's have a quick look at this again, Richard. Here's Scotty Thompson. He goes to lay some body pressure. I think the call is a high hit to Monfries' head. And the free kick stands.
That is a terrible decision, Das. That should not be a free kick any day of the week.
And Scotty Thompson, he is still filthy about it. The goal will stand, and it's an important one. Ollie Wines, he's working overtime, as he always does, that young star of a player, often on the bottom of the pack.
Lingy, are we talking ribs, body damage, or are we talking facial damage with Zeeble, do you think?
I've got to confirm that at quarter time, BT. I will be all over that, but I think it's ribs and body damage. By the way, he came off the ground, really coughing up blood, unfortunately, when he came to the bench.
Kangaroos have got the footy cracker, couldn't get through. Wingard's second defensive tackle was effective. He's a little bit sore behind play. Opportunity for the Kangaroos here, Richo.
If it was a head knock, they would have gone the 20 minutes to see if he comes good, wouldn't they?
Yeah, they would have. Yeah.
You're quite right.
That would make sense. We're just about out of time here. The footy with Ben Jacobs, who was a late inclusion. Daniel Wells, who was a late withdrawal from the game with Achilles and calf problems. There's Wingard. What an electrifying first quarter. One of the highest and fast-paced games we've seen so far this year. We've got a ripping game coming up here tonight from Etihad Stadium, BT.
Port Adelaide by 9 points. Brad Scott with us on the other side of the break. Port by 9 points at quarter time. There have been some massive hits. He's already out of the game, Zeebel. Gone for the night. Wright is having the fitness test as we speak. It has been left, right and centre. Unbelievable. North Melbourne trail. They're two straight. Port 3-3, 21 in a ripping game of footy.
Attention, please. Watch movie after movie, episode after episode of the world's most popular shows. Get more choice. Go to presto.com.au for a free 30-day trial.
Fair amount of carnage in the first quarter. Let's get straight down to Cameron Lingy. You have the latest on Jack Zeebel, and he's going to catch up with the North Melbourne coach shortly. Lingy?
Well, Das, the latest is we've been put on Twitter that Jack Zeebel may go to hospital for precautionary scans on a chest. But as Brad Scott comes up here, lots of collisions, and unfortunately you've been forced to use the sub already with Jack Zeebel. Do you have any further update on him?
No, Zeebel won't come back. He's got some internal issues, so he's coughing up some blood. So we think he'd be okay, but he's off to the hospital for scans. And Sam Wright will come back in 7 minutes once the concussion sub's expired. So two down, but fought in the contest, and a bit better ball use, we could have been in front.
Incredibly fast first quarter of footy there. Was that the plan, to have that much play on and action going on?
Oh, we knew it would be their plan. We wanted to counter that and make sure we challenge them to defend us. So we'll keep trying to do that.
Thanks, Scotty. Appreciate it.
Cameron Ling down there with Brad Scott. Very direct, and news on Zeebel is some sort of body blow, internal blood coming up there, and of course Wright is off under the concussion rule, so he's got another 13 or 14 minutes before he can come back.
Yeah, I like that from Brad Scott, isn't it? Just tell you how it is. This is what we're facing at the moment, and it was fast-paced. There was a fair bit of carnage in the first quarter. Let's get the second quarter underway.
All right, we're ready to go. If this quarter matches the first, we're all going to be pretty happy at halftime.
Matty Broadbent is the loose man at that centre bounce as we see Jack Zeebel heading out to the ambulance. Let's hope he's okay.
Yeah, heading off here under his own power, so he'll have some scans.
Here's Broadbent, 12 touches in that first quarter as the loose man back there.
Been good, Rich. Has he played that role for the entire first quarter?
Yeah, he has. He's had the 12 touches, nearly 300 metres gained.
Okay, so Jack Zeebel says goodbye to Etihad Stadium, and we say hello to the second quarter of footy underway, and North with the ball in their forward end. Goldstein doing the ruck, Ryder over the top. Thomas trying to crash through, and high tackle against Mitchell.
It's good. He takes possession of the footy here, and he charges in. He wants contact, and he drew the free kick.
Very good call by the umpire.
If he had stuck that tackle, though, BT, Mitchell would have been holding the ball, because if you take the tackle on... But he's drawn the free kick, Lindsay.
Now loves this part of the game. Went through a stage where he just absolutely hated it. Now he wants it, wants the ball in his hands. Lindsay Thomas, Mitchell questioning where the mark is. Thomas comes in and he nurses that very, very nicely. Got a poster.
Okay, to get moving pretty quickly was Pittard, told to wait until the flag has been waved. Very familiar with the kick-in duties, finds Ebert. Broadbent, the man Richo's been describing as having a lot of the football. Gets another possession now under a bit more pressure. So they've done well here, North Melbourne. You can see Andrew Swallow, the captain, Big Ben Brown, involved, and they get to keep it in their forward half of the ground.
Well, Brad Scott mentioned that at quarter time that he knew Port Adelaide, or they knew that Port Adelaide would come out wanting to play that really fast footy like they did in the first quarter. Much better defensively there to chop it off and not let them get going. They've got to do it, though, for the whole quarter.
Naha supplied some pressure. The best and fairest winner, Cunnington's got hold of Hartlett. And that will go back to the umpire. Join Goldstein and Ryder. Goldstein just about the informed ruckman in the game at the moment. Out to Wingard. Not his best effort by foot for Rito. Attlee back to Scotty Thompson. He's given that up and under job, nearly hit the roof. Goldstein split the pack wide open. You love that from your ruckman. Spills to Benny Jacobs. A one-on-one opportunity for Ben Brown. Out the back, Jackson Tringo did pretty well. Lindsay Thomas picked it up. He sold a little bit.
Good.
And then released Bastanac. He went with a fist. Maybe should have grabbed that. And we'll get another boundary throw in. But Bastanac there just second-guessed himself momentarily.
How good was that? Here we go. big Goldie. He's taken two out. That's what you want. You want your big man. Two players on the ground gives you a real advantage.
Bit of damage done there from the big fella.
How good was that by Lindsay Thomas, though?
Yep, exciting stuff, Richo. Cunnington again. Back to Jacobs. Jacobs around the corner. Put it in a dangerous spot, though. Drew Petrie made it work off hands. Bastardak into an open goal. The Roos within two.
I feel like this is an important night for Ryan Bastardak. Man on screen there. Nick Dal Santo's out for a long period of time. He was dropped after round one. A real make or break year for Bastardak. It's a big moment for him. Great front and centre. It's Goldstein. Athletically got over the top. Swallow just wheeled his way through. Lost a boot in there. I think it was a Port Adelaide player. Mason Woods, a classy left footer. That's a good one to Big Drew. Almost within range. Petrie, BT.
Not quite.
Well, he's going to set it up to the dangerous spot. Ben Brown wants to get a run at it. Goldie goes front and centre. Big Todd Goldstein. Nah, Haas couldn't pick it up off his toes. Higgins, he's been a big goal kicker in the opening two rounds. Back to Petrie. Can he get through the white tackle? Mason Wood, bit of a fumble. Boat went in after the footy. Mitchell tried to pick it up. White rag dolled into the ground. The umpire said prior opportunities. He's going to pay it. It spills out. Now Wood runs onto it. There's a hard contest. Coming the other way now. Back on the ground is Wright. McDonald picked it up. He got tackled immediately.
How's the pressure there?
Let him up now.
Incredible stuff. Just young Wood in the thick of it. Bumps and tackles and pressure absolutely coming from every angle. A great example of where the modern game's gone.
Ben Brown.
Ben Brown's won himself a free. Let's have a listen. Not letting him run, said the umpire. All over him, holding. And so Jackson Trengove has got a little itchy, and now Ben Brown. As a result, 25 metres out, the first time tonight that the Roos can hit the front, and he nails the goal. Got it, he's got a couple. North are in front by 4 points.
Now a multiple goal kicker, big Ben Brown, in 8 of 13 games played. A good habit he's in.
He does it just through movement. He always sits up with the footy.
He's a bit ungainly, Richo, but he's got more speed, I think, than it looks like when you lay eyes on him first. Ben Jacobs having an impact. Here's Mason Wood. Took a nice contested mark. Wants to get it moving. Ryder and Goldstein tracking each other. And Paddy Ryder did pretty well defensively there to get a hand on that one.
Gee, Dust, I'm loving the game so far of young Mason Wood. Only his third game for North Melbourne, but his couple of attacks on the contest before were very, very good. Created spillages for his teammates, which allowed them to lock the ball in. Then again, another strong mark. The coach would be loving it so far from Mason Wood.
Told that Brad Scott is a big fan of the way Mason Wood goes about his work. Enjoy his classy left foot kicking. Brad Scott will be feeling a little more settled. Got jumped early, Port Adelaide, but were able to hang on to the scoreboard situation as Michael Voss and Ken Hinckley watch on. Kangaroos in front for the first time in this match. This is Aaron Young involved. Strange looking unit is Young. Out to Robbie Tarrant, and now Mitchell links up with Robbie Gray. Good pressure applied there by Petrie. Pittard now's got some work to do. He did pretty well at halfback.
Hey, busted the tackle. Now he gets going. Thought about the second bounce. Will need it. Ran the full journey. Did well. Really took it right to the edge. Ebert with a fadeaway handball to Polak from 50 metres out. Long ball. Schultz had a go.
Port Adelaide.
And a free to Jay Schultz.
The umpire was in perfect position there.
And there's argument from him either.
I think he knows.
Michael.
Let's have a look. Here it is. You can just see. And a Schultz free. He's a chance to run around with this. He is a great drop punt kick, Jay Schultz. He's got that classic style. He's got to drop it perfectly straight. No time to bend the footy here. Kick on the way. And he kicks the goal. So Port regain the lead.
Eleven marks last week, Jay Schultz. Only managed the one goal. He'd be pretty happy to be on the scoreboard as Goldstein and Ryder. We're going to see a lot of that head-to-head battle tonight.
He's very capable athlete. Ryder, look at the spring there, got over the top, forcing his way through Bastinet. Higgins, he's in for this centre bounce. Nice hands from Big Goldstein out to Bastinet. A little bit up and under job, hard to mark that one. Broadbent to Cracker. Underground tumbling punt kick from Nathan Cracker, who is a really interesting story, BT, Richo and Lee. He blew out to 105 kilos after his year at the Gold Coast. He went to Western Australia, put on a heap of weight, went back in the sand full and worked his absolute heart out to find his way back on the list. He played 40 games, as we know, for Port Adelaide prior to this opportunity.
Gee, he's done well with the weight. 105 kegs, Darstadt. What would he be now, 75, 80?
Yeah, he's right down in the mid-70s. Yep. He's Nathan Cracker, 77 kilos.
Extraordinary effort. Put 25 on, basically.
It's a reasonable paddock.
That's a big paddock, that.
You really want it. Living proof. Thompson.
That must be hard to get off.
Yes. Turner. McDonald. Yeah, it would have been. Brown. So North at the moment. 2-1 in this quarter here. And interested to know what Lingy thought of Brad Scott's words at quarter time, where he said, "We knew they came to play fast." Wasn't sure whether he meant North wanted to play fast or whether they're equal to it as the ball paddles around there. What did you make of that comment, Lingy?
Well, I took it as that they wanted to play fast as well, but they also had to somehow find a way of defending that really fast ball movement of Port Adelaide. And maybe in the first quarter, especially early on in that first quarter, they just allowed them to play on from marks too easily, move the ball too easily. He'd be much happier with this second quarter, where they've been able to slow them up more. We're seeing a lot more of this, where they've had to go back behind the mark, try and hit that perfect one. Mind you, that was a perfect kick. Beautiful ball use.
Yeah, Ryder did really well. I feel like he's just starting to find his feet with a power jumper on his back. Overlap run provided by Alapati Carlisle, and now Schultz. He's more than happy to work up the ground. He's got a runner out wide, Hamish Hartlett. And a fairly quiet start to the year by his standards. Kick out wide, looking for Wingard. Wingard, be able to keep that one in.
Well, they had one and ones inside 50 there, Port Adelaide, but North Melbourne did really well, forced them to kick the ball wide.
So let's see what Port Adelaide can do here with the trap. Bit of a wide shot there. You can see how they've surrounded the play here. Very few North Melbourne players on the extreme perimeter of where the ball is. All Port Adelaide. Here's Wood, the left footer. Interesting stage of the game. Port by a point. Ryder, Goldstein, over the back. Just repeating, if you've just joined us, Jack Siebel taken to hospital. Precautionary check there. Internals as Cracker goes long and deep over the back. Even here's Schultz. Got White there. White didn't even look. Did not hesitate. It's a great around the body kick. Geez, good. 7-point lead. Port, he's got a couple.
Yeah, North, as you can see there, had the 3-on-2, had the loose player. The ball got over the back, stayed in the corridor, and Matty White made them pay.
Justin Westhoff taking a turn, the ruck, centre bounce. Goldstein was a bit too big on that occasion. Hartlett at half back. He's got Pittard linking up. And probably pretty effective with the left foot on that occasion. That was always going to be Scotty Thompson's ball. Too tall for his opponent, Matt White. Just get an opportunity now to take a breath in this game. It was incredibly frenetic first quarter. I think that was possible to sustain that onslaught. The players just feeling their way through. Aaron Young into Pittard. He's happy to weave his way through a little bit of traffic. Now kicks back and Thompson's going to do it all again.
Uncharacteristically, Port have tried to go over the top quite a few times when there hasn't been a Port player to the advantage. There's Broadbent. He tries to whack it over the top again, and once again, no Port player in position.
Yeah, North have got a really good setup now.
And on top of that, BT, I reckon Port Adelaide are just a little bit tired. They haven't quite got the runners from behind being able to link up. They're forced to kick.
Opportunity here as Atlee takes them deep inside. Forward 50 again. Been good tonight, Pittard. But you can see that shot there down the ground. There's Scott Thompson. So they won't be able to go fast here.
Wines, puts the needle in the middle. Ebert got one on either side of him.
just pulls the kick slightly. Wanted White to come at him. White did really well against Jacobs. Now he plays on. Kick wasn't so good along the ground. Jay Schultz wanted it. Still got an opportunity. Fed out the nice handball. Ebert tried to avoid the Thompson tackle. Wood to Harvey. North standing up to every port challenge at the moment.
It has slowed down a bit, though. They're not quite running into space like they were in the first quarter, the players.
Opportunity again here for Port Adelaide, bursting through the other way. Was a little boomer. Harvey got hold of the footy. He won a good contested ball. Lindsay Thomas, Mason Wood. Good tackle, pressure from the Kangaroos. Harvey gets it again, playing permanent halfback. Look at the run. Crowd get behind him. He's going to take a second and third bounce. No, gives it off. He's got some good run provided out there. Gibson, or was it Waite, out the back. Pushing hard is Ferrito. The numbers with Port Adelaide. So the loose man in defence is that man Broadbent, and he has had a field day. This is possession number 15 coming up for that man.
It's a bizarre game of footy, Richard. It really is. Bizarrely good.
Well, it's just who can use the ball better in these situations when there's a number back.
Holak. I've noticed all players from both teams trying to really chisel and hit the ball hard. Rather than get a little bit more loop in the footy. I think they've got to get it there as quick as they can. Maybe it's the pressure of this game. Thompson happy to concede the behind. James Schultz there, and been a lot of this going on all over the play. This is just normal.
Scotty loves to niggle, doesn't he?
Interesting way to get out of the tackle there.
Oh boy. So this is little Kane Turner. Only 67 kilos worth of Kane Turner, but he's getting a reputation, boys, as a bit of a wrecking ball. In his first game of AFL football, he knocked out Phil Davis from the GWS. In his second game, he cleaned up Rory Laird from the Crows. In round one this year, he had a big hit that he laid on Paddy Dangerfield. So for a little jockey size, Kane Turner does some damage. Waite, well, that was ambitious. And Trengo said, good luck getting past me.
Jay Short's in trouble, boys. Jay Short's coming off with a leg injury as well.
Stay out. We'll get Lingy to give us an update on that. Jared Waite, umpire, not having a piece of this, wanted a reversal and might have just made the most of that one. Jared Waite, what can you tell us down there, Lingy?
Well, he's still bent over. It did look like he made the most of it. I don't know. There must have been some contact because he's hurting a bit. North Melbourne are open now, though.
They are indeed. Ferrito to Nahas needs to use it well. He does to Lindsay. And Thomas marks within range. He's got Gibson with a little chippy over the top and does it nicely.
Well, he's having an enormous night, Gibson. This will be his 20th disposal. And we're just over halfway through the second quarter.
Best runner at North Melbourne is Gibson. Yeah. Just a running machine.
It suits him then, Lingy, this game.
Absolutely. And just pushing hard inside 50 then. Just burned off the Port Adelaide opposition by pure hard work and hard running. Great effort.
Good stats there, weren't they? For this man, Gibson, 45-degree angle right behind him here. And has no trouble converting whatsoever. Back within 2 points, the Roos.
Yeah, he's having an enormous...
See a replay here, Lingy, of Schultz.
Yeah, you can see just stood on the ankle there, lower leg. He's just walking past me, walking okay. Pretty keen to get back out there.
I think a strap will be all right, Darcy.
He should be okay. We've had a bit of damage done so far in this game. If you just joined us, Jack Zeeble's in hospital. He's got a chest issue, coughing up blood, and will take no further part in this game. We wish him well. Boomer Harvey at halfback, starting to accumulate a bit of the footy. Little Boomer, always dangerous when he gets hold of it. They push hard forward, back with the flight. Went Mason Wood, like the way he's gone about it tonight. Big Ben Brown gets involved to Nahas. He's going to try and take on the defender in Pittard. Kick was okay in the Lindsay Thomas direction. Lindsay just didn't quite get hold of it, as Matt White has got a bit of a limp up down there as well.
There is the replay. Another stomping. Oh. That was almost identical to the Paddy Ryder one. So they're like trotters getting tangled up in the final straight. Has Krakua through traffic to Mitchell.
50 metres here. 50 metres. High. 50 metres.
Downfield.
So this is an interesting decision. It was high.
And he's got, was it after he got rid of the ball?
Yeah, it was.
So, Chris Dong, let's just have a little look at what we're talking about. got rid of it. Gee, I reckon it was when he got rid of it, Darce.
And that was my eyebrow raised, I suppose, but the 50 stands.
Momentary it was, if at all. Cracker goes wide, and good stuff by Gray. Through one, and now an opportunity at goal, and sprays it right.
As his recovery, Robbie Gray turns so quickly. Thought he would take that mark then. He didn't, but his effort to recover and turn, he can do everything. His clearance in the middle before was unbelievable as well. He gets his hands free and gets handballs off when other players wouldn't be able to.
And Matt White exits the ground. He's got severe limp up. He'll get that re-strapped. Wing guard. He's worked pretty hard defensively tonight. Now a little bit of space for Hart. This man can seriously kick a football outside 60. Sized it up. Hartlett didn't get it online. And an opportunity missed there for Hamish Hartlett.
Darcy mentioned Matty White coming off the ground. He's getting checked out right now by the doctors. And as you said, hopefully just strapped up, but not really happy. The good news was, though, the man who replaced him back on the field was Jay Schultz. He's OK. There is a lot happening down here on the benches.
Harvey now, just a half-back, inching the ball forward. By the way, Anna Mears has tweeted through, cheering on a Port Adelaide Football Cup from Canberra, where she's in a training camp. Of course, a prolific gold medal-winning athlete for Australia over a long period of time now.
One of our greatest ever Olympians, Anna Mears.
Indeed. Here we go with Attlee. Little sliding kick to McDonald. He's got a bit of time and space here, McDonald. He too likes the left. Long ball. Here comes Goldstein. Almost got it. Now at ground level. Gibson through traffic. Handball smothered by Hops. Attlee to Higgins. Higgins has a little go at it. Just dragged it a little. Minor score. 5 minutes remain in the half. Tight game, half a goal in at Port's way.
Goes to show the fatigue of these players, though. Sean Higgins and then previously Hamish Hartlett, both beautiful kicks of the ball. You would have put down both of those players for certain goals, but the players out here are exhausted. It's been a high-intensity game from start to right now. Great work, Drew Petrie, though, to force a boundary throw-in. They are not letting up at all.
Just got a little look at the flames tattooed on Matty White's ankles, Richo. You gave us an exclusive last week that was the case.
Yeah, he's pretty happy with them too, Whitey.
What happens when he's 80?
Just a mistake he made there when he was a bit younger, Whitey, I think.
The old flaming ankles. As we see Swallow, he's wrapped up. That one won't be coming out.
There they are. I haven't seen many purple flames around before.
So his dream would be to train in bare feet or play in bare feet.
Yeah, he used to cough a bit, Whitey, for those flames.
Goldstein got it down to Bastanac. Hurry kick. This is a good bounce. Might open the door for Waite here. Cracker. Looping handball over the top. Alipatic Carlisle. Happy to see that one through for a minor score. 2-point margin. Final 4.75 minutes in the first half.
Boak. Back to Pittard. He's done well with possession number 11 for him. Used it pretty good. Now Paddy Ryder. Can they find a clean way through this time? Here's Wines. He offers something. Both hands on it. Well done by Wright not to infringe, but to bring the ball to the ground. And he recovers here. Little handball back inside. Stepped out of the way. Nicely done by Turner. Now the ball's in the path of McDonald. Hartlett's there. He wants to corral rather than go at him. Gives him an opportunity to spear it in. Once again, another one of those spearing kicks that hasn't quite come off tonight. Wingard and Wines work it down. They had to go. Gee, Gray looks like he's got lead in the boots at the moment there. Opportunity at the back here. North with the numbers again. Slowed down by Jacobs.
And North are just winning a few more crucial one-on-ones at the moment in this second quarter.
You feel like the loose man's work maybe slightly better this quarter for the Kangaroos, although now a chance for Ebert. Forced it forward to Gray. He's a chance to kick it from there. Gives it to Pittard. Lines it up with the left foot. Jesper Pittard. He slices it through. Big goal for Port Adelaide.
So Pittard there, really composed shot at goal under pressure. And Porter 8 points up with just 3 minutes to play in this first half. Ryder over the top, Hartlett, Young, back to Hartlett. Interesting handball, Mitchell. Not sure what to do, little funny kick outside. Gray back to Mitchell, running machine Mitchell. Here he is at half forward, goes in there looking for the lead, and the mark's taken by Monfries.
Yeah, nice kick. He lowered his eyes. He didn't blaze away because Wright was a loose man. He would have marked a long ball.
A bit too far out for Monfries here. So he just centres the ball. Ryder elevates, got one hand up, couldn't get the other. Now an opportunity for Higgins. Here's Wood. We know he's a left footer. Goldstein distributes to McDonald. McDonald with great vision finds Wade at half back.
He looks up and sees absolutely nothing, Jared Wade. So he's going to wait. Kane Turner pushes half forward. Wood, who started the play, and Waite's kick was poor, taken by Hartland. Now Broadbent, he's had a heap of the footy. Disposal number 16 for that man. Robbie Gray's a great one-on-one player.
Well done.
Perito did really well, Richo.
Oh, it's Spuddy Perito. He never gives up on a contest. I thought Robbie Gray had that. The old stager, Perito, just got there in time.
Number 233 for North Melbourne, Michael Perito. So he's been a reliable, consistent performer.
Just competes, does, every week.
So, closing in on half-time, and these are really crucial minutes. As Young, he got a bit more space than maybe he thought. That's a bit too easy. Ebert snap round the body. That's a couple in a row for the power.
Well, North Melbourne players here just be disappointed in a broken tackle. Then they stayed away from Aaron Young, maybe drifting past the contest a little bit, allowed that handball to Brad Ebert. Well finished by him, but Young shouldn't have been able to get that ball out in the first place.
So 2:10 remaining here in the half. Wines, great little handball. Pollack, Ryder, back to Wines again. They're on the charge here at the moment, Port Adelaide. They've kicked four of the last five goals, and they've got another opportunity here with Jay Schultz. And he is definitely within range.
Time back on. Just here.
Getting the job done out of the middle.
Yeah, he's on the whole way, Scotty. Earlier than that. Coach, one's good.
Scotty's had a question on all of the decisions today.
You know what? The forwards always do that.
It's a sneaky one, and he's right.
And they always initiate it, and the defender always gets pinged.
And he knew that the umpire couldn't see his grip on the jumper of Thompson then. So here is Jay Schultz, three in a row. And he nails the goal. They've got five of the last six in this game, Port Adelaide, as we near half-time.
An old tactic of yours, this one, Richo. The stiff arm out, and you think maybe the defender, Scotty Thompson's been lucky.
He's stiff because Jay Schultz initiated that. Forwards always use that stiff arm, hold the jumper a little bit. The defender can't get near it, and he gets pinged every time. Bristol would have used that on occasion, I reckon, down at Vic Park.
Well, yes, Richo, I don't remember and recall, but I'm sure...
You never held the jumper of the opposition.
But it's a really good point you make, really good point.
I'm amazed to hear you guys saying that the forwards always get the decision. I would have thought you'd be arguing that the defenders always get favoured.
In that sort of case, the forward gets the advantage, Lingy. We'll give you that one.
Hiddard at half-back. It's been a hard-charging game in Port Adelaide. Over the top, didn't stick it. I've seen less than that paid this round. And Paddy's was not. Let's have another look at the high-flying Paddy Ryder as he launches. Great athleticism. Both jukes on it. That would have been a sensational grab from Paddy.
Just starting to find his feet, Paddy Ryder. You know, he didn't get the pre-season base that he would have liked, but he's looking really comfortable now. Change of directions, good set beautifully for Alapati. He releases Jonas White. An opportunity here. Cracker, he's normally good by foot, and he'll find Monfries. Oh, no, took his eye off it, Angus. Kick around the body, touch play on the call. McDonald hasn't heard it. Neither's Pollack. So McDonald, good enough to get it to Thompson. We've got 12 seconds remaining in the first half. He's going to have to get it back and work his way through Luke McDonald. Time might just run out here for the Kangaroos. It'll sit for Wood. He needs to get it moving, takes a bounce, and that will be the half. So it was the Kangaroos streaming forward, but the last three goals of the quarter, five of the last six went the way of the power. We've got a good contest here at halftime, a 20-point margin in favour of the power.
Absolutely nothing in it, Das. Great game. Stay with us. Plenty more on the other side of this. North Melbourne, 5-4-34. Trail Port, 8-6-54. Yeah, the little fellas, the NAB Oz kick, it's famous around Australia. It's how all the guns that are playing here tonight get their start. Whether you're a ruckman, a rover, a left-handed bouncer, it doesn't matter. You can just dance. You don't actually have to play the game. Just go and have fun. And I tell you what, this is not a lot of fun if you're in the middle of it. North Melbourne and Port Adelaide. It is a sensational game. Port by 20 points. Richo, second half, and the steam hasn't completely gone out of this one by any means.
No, it hasn't, BT, but an interesting point made by Sam Gibson at halftime with Cameron Ling. He said that we need to get a bit of pace out of this game because I don't think we can keep going at this rate, and I think he's right. I think if it stays like this, I think it suits Port Adelaide. We know how much they like this game. They've been playing it for a long time this way. They haven't been able to get it on their terms in the first two rounds. Freo and Sydney held them up. North haven't been able to quite do that tonight. So that will be the big focus in the second half for North Melbourne.
And I feel like they'll be a little bit disappointed in their forward set up. They've got a lot more talent this year. We've got Waite down there and Petrie and Big Ben Brown, Sean Higgins and Lindsay Thomas. Five goals in the first half. They'll feel like it's nowhere near the return that they would expect. Waite kicked seven last week. They need just a little bit more productivity out of that forward half.
All right, here we go. Second half about to get underway. Bounce record. By the way, Richo, what do you think of Kane Corns not getting a game this week? Given the fact that he's been such a great champion for them, he's their games record holder, four-time best and fairest.
Yeah, look, I thought he may have played tonight and had the role on Boomer Harvey, but Ken Hinckley wants to make sure he plays, you know, 15 or 16 really good games and is up and running at the right end of the year.
Fair enough. Swallow went forward. Alapati Carlisle also goes forward. It's just like a game of tennis. It's just over the net, back and forth. There's Goldstein. Probably jumped when he didn't need to, the big fella there. Thompson took him on, or Attlee it was. Got it to Thomas. Bit of a fired off the play here as a result of this decision. So it'll be with Lindsay.
He's played that against Pittard, who was having a wrestle with the big boy Goldstein.
Thomas plays on, and he'll tell you what, he's got it right to the goal line. Higgins didn't know whether it was in the points or the goals. At least that's what he'll say.
Yeah, sloppy.
This is what led to it all. He kicks the goal, and all of a sudden it's on again.
Here's another look at the free kick that was paid downfield, resulting in a goal. Not a lot in it from
6-1, half a dozen of the other there. Just let's let that go, I reckon. We're big boys. There's going to be a few little wrestles in a physical game like this.
It's Hartlett reefed it out of the hands of Bastinet. It might have been a tug of the jumper on Monfries. It will be a free kick. Advantage has been paid. Ollie Wines, a little champ. He's got a target he likes in Wingard. Well, he weighted it perfectly in between two Kangaroos defenders. And Chad Wingard, very, very talented goal kicker, this man.
He certainly is. This is a great kick. You called it, Darce. It was just a weighted kick. Perfectly placed for this man, who is a great goal kicker, we know that. The centre square clearances have been a concern all night, and that was another one there for Port Adelaide. They're on top in that area.
He hasn't had the scoreboard impact that we've come to expect from this man, Chad Wingard. He punches it, and they get the quick response. Chad Wingard kicks his first goal of the night.
Just a nice little centre clearance here from Hamish Hartlett, just pinching it from out the back of Ryan Bastinac. Beautiful play. They are dominating the centre bounces at the moment. 10-3 the centre clearances to Port Adelaide North. They've got to fix that one up.
It's right up. Straight down the middle. Hartlett will make it work. Did really well with the body and then managed to get a peg on it as well. Ferrito trying with desperation to repel. They're under enormous Port Adelaide pressure here at the moment. Tarrant with a driving tackle on Jay Schultz.
Stay there, mate.
That was rock solid.
Thanks, Jay.
Really crucial next 5 minutes here for North Melbourne. Port are getting it out of the centre, getting momentum going their way. They wouldn't want to let it get out to a five-goal break.
Right, a basketball style. Flicked that out back to Robbie Gray, and he was almost away. Swallows in there. He'll need to make an attempt to get rid of it. Umpire balls it up again within striking distance for Port Adelaide. We mentioned the game's record holder. There he is, Kane Corns.
Yeah, an interesting call that, isn't it? Just managing him through this season. Closing in on 300 games, Kane Corns. He's been an absolute champion of the Port Adelaide Power Footy Club. Ben Brown gives chase. Jonas probably happy. That one will go across the boundary line.
I think it's a smart move, what they've done with Kane Corns. Just make sure his body is right and ready to go come later on in the year. He's important to them. Plays that shutdown role. He's that experienced head, but he also finds a heap of the footy in the midfield, as he's always done his whole career.
Speaking of finding the footy, Sam Gibson coming up for disposal, 21. He released a couple of runners here. Higgins kicked the last goal for North Melbourne. Looping handball to Lindsay Thomas. He's going to go with a centering ball on the right foot. Can Petrie get back with a flight? He can get there. Well played. Thomas's kick was perfectly weighted in the end, Richo, and Petrie did the rest.
Yeah, it was a sensational kick, but give Drew Petrie some credit here. His work to run back to the goal square, and then he had to turn.
15 gone, Drew.
And he just got there. They got the fingertips to it, but it was great work from him to even get into that position.
We said they needed more out of their big forwards. Big Drew's going to deliver his first goal of the night. We're back to a 14-point ball game.
Two goals to one in this quarter already, favouring the Roos. Thus, the margin trimmed from 20 to 14. Can Port Adelaide continue to respond to the challenges from North? Went without it on that occasion. Wingard came back and had a second go at it and did really well. Flick out handball, Ebert, Wingard involved. Look at the linking chain of running players. Broadbent out the side door. Little left foot kick. It was an inching ball. It was a great kick. Really well done to Young. Young immediately wheels around on the right, lets it go. They've got a three on one here over the back to Schultz. Couldn't control it. Gibson now, Bastanac, inching little kick. And under pressure here, the Roos, they need to be careful the way they tiptoe out of defence. Quick hands, great stuff. Nahas hemmed in on the boundary line. There's the pressure. Now they'll force the turnover, or at least the nil-all draw. They've got the turnover. Jonas out the back door. Broadbent again. Thomas working hard. Well done here. Ferrito, an opportunity. He just bangs it on the boot and got it as far away as he could.
He just wanted it as far out of the defensive area as you could, BT. And now Brown's got to work out. He did well, put some pressure on Mason Wood. He's a classy left foot kick. Flying shot at the goal from Wood. It'll bounce across the face. First man back there is Kane Mitchell. We mentioned his running ability before. He and Kane Corns go head-to-head in the pre-season time trial. Bristol Corns just gets him the 3K of it.
Hey.
Not a lot in it. Bonfries has got to contend with a couple. Higgins did well to keep his feet. Get the feeling this one's going to come back inside 50. Petrie, he stands tall here. Carlisle did well. Ricochets back now to the hands of Goldstein. Goldie's got a bit of time and a clever kick to Nahas within range.
This is a great comeback here from North Melbourne at the start of this third quarter. Just look at this spoil here. Did it well, Sean Higgins. We know that you can infringe coming back like that. He did it beautifully.
Had 8 score involvements last week at the win over the Brisbane Lions. Former Richmond player Nahas. These are the goals small forwards just have to kick. Robin Nahas, he gives it some height and he sneaks it in. Kangaroos back within 8 points.
So Nahas gets his first. North have got 3 in 8 minutes here in the third quarter and back to 8.
They've got it from just 4 inside 50s. Their 3 goals, their forward half is now just starting to function the way that they would have hoped from the start.
Indeed it is. Back in the middle we go again. There's an opportunity for Gray to run onto the ball. Little left foot pass as well was really good to Young. Ferrito, did he take him forward of the tackle? The umpire calls play on. Fair enough. Fans not happy.
They're just never getting first use of it out of the middle, North Melbourne. All of their play at the moment is having to start in Port Adelaide's forward half. And that's what's making it a little hard for their key forwards. They're never getting first crack at it in a traditional forward line setup.
Gray trying to spin out, lost control of the footy. Swallow G right almost threw it to Wood. Handball Tarrant. And that was a really fast, heavy handball from Tarrant there when the man was so close. Now they come out wide to Alapati. Carlisle couldn't get control. Monfries almost shirt fronted Lingy. Lingy, you were within 3 metres and you just about got cleaned up.
I just realised why I've happily retired, BT, because that was a big contact and they were moving very, very fast. They're big boys out there. They hit hard.
And even the little ones do damage. I told you, Kane Turner, he's a little wrecking ball, 67 kilos of him. That's the little man there, and he has cleaned up some bigger opponents, Richo. Starting to get a reputation, I promise you.
He loves the contest.
He loves the physical side of the game, and they're out again here. Atlee, he's got speed. He's going to take Young on. He'll get through the corridor. Now launches one to Ben Brown. Ben Brown's got his name all over it. Jeez. The big Tasmanian, Richo. He led well. He looks ungainly, but he's got speed.
He has, and he did really well then. He held his lead to exactly the right time. His teammate up the field, Atlee, was ready to deliver.
Yeah, it's nice play that from Atlee, isn't it?
So you see this here. He burnt off. He waited. Now, down there, Benny Brown waited. He waited until Atlee was settled and ready to kick, and then he made his lead, and the pass was perfect.
Finally, some forward 50 marks for the Kangaroos. It's 4-1. What can big Ben Brown do? He loads up Ben Brown. Kangaroos have got three in a row. We're back to 2 points.
There's Benny Brown. He loves it. It was down at Arden Street a couple of weeks ago doing something, and I was watching him do his goal kicking out on the ground. He was out there for about an hour and a half practicing his set shot routine, and it's paying dividends. He's not missing.
Three in a row, four in the quarter. Here comes a pumped up Ben Brown. This time the ball went past him. Wade says, I want to have a go at this. He goes the right foot banana from the boundary, and he sprays it across the face. So North on fire. They are within 2 points. It's taken them 11 minutes of footy to trim the lead back.
We've got an opportunity again here. Deep inside 50. Apply some real pressure. Harvey's lurking. Goldstein working his man underneath. It was it a push in the back? No free kick doing. Ryder got dispossessed. Bastanac tried to bust through. Wood circling as well.
Look at the pressure.
Great pressure from Cunnington. And now Pittard. He's got to go to the right foot. How will this one bounce? Atlee did really well on Monfries on the edge of 50. Came up with a footy too. Robbie Tarrant, he's been a goal kicker before. He loved it off the boot. Four in a row, the Kangaroos have got the lead back. And have a look at Robbie Tarrant.
Have a look at him. That's what you love. He's sprinting back to the back line. That was just sustained pressure from North Melbourne. Have a look at it. And it forced Pittard just to hack the ball out. They're all over Port Adelaide at the moment. Port have had 23 disposals for the quarter. North have tackled 12 times. Every time they get the footy, they're in their face. And they deserve to be in the lead. It's been a great start to this quarter.
Nice celebration too from Robbie Tarrant. It's a man who had a really rare nerve-related leg issue. Some doubt about how he's going to come back into footy. Only played the one game last year, and he's pumped up, Bristol.
Are you coaching Lingy and you're coaching Port Adelaide? What do you want to do for the next 5 minutes?
Well, somehow you've just got to get control back of the ball, and that is, first of all, by winning it in the contest. But if you take a mark, I reckon take the pace off the game a little bit. I know Port Adelaide like to play that high energy, but at the moment, North Melbourne are playing better high energy, so maybe slow it down a touch.
Goal at the 1 minute mark, the 5 minute mark, the 8 minute mark, the 11 minute mark, the 12 minute mark. They're on fire, the Roos, and they are now in front by 4 points. Boak a little confused. Eventually, he straightens himself up, goes long, but once the game, the kick is not fantastic to Westhoff. Tarrant had first go at it. Gee, Westhoff almost threw it out to Broadbent. He straightens the kick up, long ball into Wingard. Wingard will play on. Handball into the goal square. Oh, did he mess it up, Monfries? He has. Must have been a touch there somehow. We'll get a chance to replay that when this slows down. But in the meantime, Bastanac back into play.
Well, look at the look there on the power fans behind the goal. That tells a big story, doesn't it? Umpires called play on. Kane Turner was spoiled by Jonas. He did well, Turner. He wants to go on with it, Jonas. Look at the heat in this one.
North Melbourne free kick. North Melbourne kick. Let him up.
Oh, well done. Kick. Thought he was going to pay a 50. Well done by the umpire not to pay it there.
His teammates love him, Kane Turner. They absolutely love him. Huge in last year's final series in the lead-up. They thought he played a major part with his forward pressure. The youngest man still at school.
He's fearlessly too. He loves the body contact for a little man.
Absolutely, Darcy. He's doing it tonight. And his teammates are lifting around him. It's great to watch.
Hey, Lingy, what about Travis Bogey's? Just a little bit down again tonight. What have you thought of his game?
Yeah, he's only had the 12 possessions, Richo. Really well held at the moment. I don't think it's been a strict job on him. I think it's been a bit of a team effort. But as we just have a quick look here at why that wasn't a goal, Angus Monfries right on the line, Ryan Bassanac got his foot there. Great desperation, but Boak's one who can lift for Port Adelaide. The skipper, he can get them going again.
Great vision from our cameras there. Perfect shot of it from the overhead. Now an opportunity for Jacobs to go wide for North Melbourne again. Nahas with a claw in front of Cracker. Cracker's got him in the tackle, rolls him over. Nahas doing his best. Boy, the North Melbourne fans up and about right now here at Etihad. Boak doing the ruck work. What about that? Got it to Mitchell. Mitchell over the top to Hartlett. A real good opportunity for a penetrating forward-bound ball. Westhoff knocks it to himself. That's got to be a mark. That has to be a mark.
I think Scotty Thompson was in front. He must have got a touch on it, BT.
Oh, boy, Richo.
They're not happy.
I'm with them at the moment without having seen the replay. First glance to me was that he got the tap on it over the back to himself. Gibson marks the inbound ball. Turner had the ball knocked away from him by Jonas. Let's have a look at that one.
Well, here you go, BT.
Westhoff. There it is. Gee. I reckon you pay that, don't you?
I reckon they both touched it at the same time.
Oh, Richo.
Well, you just got to call it how you see it, BT.
Umpire right on the spot. He was convinced that there was a fingernail on it from Thompson. They've had a couple of opportunities. And a free kick will go the way of Young here.
In the tackle.
Back in the side, Aaron Young. Played a career high 14 games in 2014. Plays all over the ground. Aaron Young now. Good look at what he's got on offer.
Playoff.
Not a heap of movement for him. Schultz doubles back. Monfrey's there. Kangaroos appear. Another number. Oh. Schultz got some great height. Thrown out by Wingard, surely. Oh. Westhoff, he's going to get around a couple. Back to Wingard. He mucked one up before. He's kicked it into the man on the mark. Bastanac. Now Port Adelaide through Schultz. Back to Wingard. Higgins. Mitchell comes in. Boak wants to get involved. Polak lurking as well. What can Ebert do in game 150? Mitchell squeezing handball back to Polak. Trengove. It was smothered partially off the boot. Ryder. Jacobs will see this out if he can. And we'll get a chance to take our breath unless it's deliberate. Oh, he's paid it.
I don't know what he can do there. I just don't know what else he can do.
Well, he got pinged and now Pittard. And look at Port.
He's hard up against the boundary line. What, do you just run over the line with it? Or what do you do, BT?
Just kick it down the line as good as you can.
That's
so I'm with you.
That's what he did, though.
Yes, he did. And he relied on the ball either bouncing one way or the other.
Unfortunately, that's the one where maybe you don't even take possession of it. The clever defenders just pretend to fumble it, let it go over the line, because the kick was always going to go out of bounds.
Cracker to just stabilise a little, goes with the short pass and finds an opportunity here with White. And I reckon White's almost a certainty to run around here. And look at that. Higgins aware of it.
I'll get him. Back with me now. Short.
White concerned about Higgins. Not so much the man on the mark, but the man to the side. So North Melbourne switched on. They're all over it. White will now perhaps be forced to go straight at it. They are in desperate need of a goal here, Port. It's a really tough shot across the face. Up they fly off hands. Westhoff, little goal, got it. Port back in business and back in front. AFL's vision here. You can see from the roof. You can see Westhoff clearly get boot on it. Or did he? Did he actually get a boot on it? Was it the second time when it was in the air he got a touch on it?
Well,
I tell you what, from that vision, I don't think he did initially.
The goal umpire's called a goal. I'm not sure Westhoff touched it. I think Monfrey's touched it over the line.
Now, it's not completely over the line there when Monfrey's touches it.
That's a goal, isn't it?
It's a goal, yeah.
It's a Monfrey's goal,
It's a Monfrey's goal. You're quite right, not a Westhoff goal. And it definitely changed the direction of the ball, the Monfrey's one, so pretty sure it'll be a Monfrey's goal. I'm right in saying the ball's got to be all the way over, doesn't it?
Yes.
Yep, 100%.
Review complete. Confirmed goal.
So it is a goal, but we're going to mark it down to Angus Monfrey's. And Port have got the one they so desperately needed to run to stop the run of North Melbourne goals at four in a row.
Yeah, it was well done by Westhoff. He had a run at the ball. We haven't seen him be able to run and jump at the footy that many times tonight inside 50, but he did that. He got a good leap at it, and his recovery was great. And Monfrey's finished it off, and as you can see there, they needed it. Four North Melbourne goals in a row. They're back in the lead.
Yeah, it's Brad Scott and Ken Hinckley. Some pressure building in this contest. Don't go anywhere. We've got an absolute ripper on our hands. Kangaroos have loaded up with their big guns in there. Cunnington, Swallow the captain. There's Cunnington, the best and fairest winner. Goldstein, they combine nicely. It's been an issue for them, the centre clearance. They get one deep. Ben Brown's down there. Pittard, he played it well.
Darcy mentioned that they put Ben Cunnington into the centre bounce there. He's only had the seven possessions tonight. Really well held. Hartlett's had a bit of a job on him at times, but most of the time they've just taken their turns to beat him in a contest. He can lift for North Melbourne and try and get them home.
Hops through the middle as a long, loping left footer. He gives White an aerial opportunity here. Jacobs did well back in, didn't keep his feet. White can run into an open goal. He does. Port fans are going bananas behind the goals.
Oh, he limped there. Has he done something?
May have done a string. He ran so fast.
Oh, I think he has. He's disappointed, BT.
Port Adelaide by 9 points. And I think he's stringed it, Matty White.
He's got his leg heavily taped here. And has he run too far? It's a goal. It's paid. But, gee, he had a lot of steps there, Whitey. He takes short steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
Oh, and I think he did it after the kick.
Well, remember he did a bit of an ankle issue, Richo, yes, earlier in the game. I love Richo's counting, by the way. That was something to... So maybe he's just given that ankle a little bit of a tweak. He had it re-strapped. We saw the flames on his leg. So ankle is a better result than a soft tissue. I think he's gone off the ground, Matty White.
No, up forward, Dust.
Okay, good result there.
Quick back hand on the steps. I reckon he ran a bit too far, Dust.
Jesus.
How long are you allowed at 50? How long is it? I don't even know.
15.
It's Richo. Boomer Harvey gets back in. He's given it straight to Robbie Gray. They've kicked the last two. Gray goes with it outside of the boot. Just one to try and maintain a little bit of time and keep it inside 50. It was a kick to touch almost as Turner gets involved. Wraps up Broadbent. And I think that was what Robbie Gray was after. A little reset. Make sure it remained in their forward half of the ground.
It's certainly the ankle, guys, with Matty White, not the not any soft tissue, even as he approached the ball in the boundary there. Just pulled up a little bit short, a bit proppy. But it looks like he's going to play forward probably for most of the night.
OK, well, that's the injury from the first half, so that's better news. Here's Wingard, gathers possession. This is not beyond him. Didn't get all of it. It was a good smothering attempt by Gibson in the end to just get a little tiny piece of it. Now Tarrant mops it up and goes it out wide to Big Ben Brown. Brown's there. Does well. Didn't keep his feet. Jonas did. Brown's got to recover. He does with a partial smother. And this Ben Brown is fantastic. He's a guy that was actually recruited by Werribee. Scott West, when he was coaching down there, and the boys got hold of him. They've developed him nicely. North Melbourne have gone, thank you very much, West End Werribee. We'll have him.
Did North know about him before he went to Werribee, or did they pick him up down there?
No, I think
they noticed him down there.
I think it was a Werribee recruit initially.
Right, yeah.
Ryder and Goldstein have been battling right throughout this game. Here is the man Bristol speaks of, Ben Brown. It was a little throw, I think. Just a little throw. Kangaroo fans, have a look at that bloke. He's going off his head.
That's a...
He's got a half a knuckle on it.
I reckon he handballed it.
Dangerous ball into the corridor. West off. He's worked off his man, Ferrito. Punching footy. Looked pretty good for Shields. Getting back Tarrant.
Can North now slow Port down? And can they have another little period before three-quarter time?
So 5.5 minutes remaining in the third term. It's four unanswered by the Kangaroos. They got the lead. And now the power of hit back, as Richo just pointed out, to lead it again by 9 points. So important. Last few minutes remaining in the third quarter. Wright just goes to one-step barrel. Brown's got to compete with a couple. And Alapati was just a bit too big and too strong on that occasion.
Oh, Alapati, Carlisle. There's Pittard through the middle of the ground. Goes with a long lefty. Thompson attacks it in the air.
Go behind your mark.
Well done. Being a little petty there. Let it go up. Thompson brings the ball back. Short ball to Tarrant. Tarrant, little handball, McDonald. We know he's a left footer. Thought about it momentarily. There's the little miniature wrecking ball Turner. Got it into Petrie.
Oh, Higgins
a little sticky. Over the top they come. Higgins is there, accepts, gives it to Wood. He's running onto his favoured left side. Keep going, mate. That's where you kick it well. Centering ball. Thomas goes up. Off hands. Opportunity. Harvey. Left foot snap. Goal. Something out of nothing. Well done there, Brent Harvey.
Yeah, well done, Boomer. That's his bread and butter. And well done, Lindsay Thomas. He was the marking forward who made a contest. Boomer Harvey does this so well. Look at that. He was just perfectly placed for the front and square. Didn't get past the footy. And how many goals have we seen him kick like that, Boomer?
Kangaroos have had six goal quarters this third quarter. All different options. Six individual goal kickers for the quarter. And Boomer played a bit at half back. He's been released forward now. Great contest we have. I feel like this one's going to go right down to the wire. Ryder and Goldstein. The ruckman left the ground. Wingard started half back and he just burst through the centre. Normally good on his left foot. Kick was waited for Schultz. He had his arm grabbed. I think Scotty Thompson's not going to be happy again.
This could send him over the edge, Darcy.
He might lose it completely here, Scotty Thompson.
I'll bet you Jay's got his jumper again. I'll bet you.
I've had a good look at that early as well.
Yes, he has. See,
it's the stiff arm tactic, and you were all over it, Richo. You had a piece of the jumper.
They always play the defender, but look at Schultz's side, his jumper. That's two tonight.
The pull-down tactic.
Jay Schultz, an opportunity to hit back immediately. What can Schultz do? 35 metres out, he rarely misses. Schultz gets his third goal, and the Power lead it by 9 points.
Never thought I'd hear the day, Richo, where you were giving away in-house big forward secrets.
It happens, though, all the time.
Because the big forwards around the league are just shivering now because you've given away their main trick. Out of the middle they go with a young kick. Wide. They're really coming here, Port. Wide tried to knock it on. Wright was there to keep him honest. McDonald handball. Wright almost stepped out of play. Sends it down the line. It did go out of play, in fact. Brad Scott just a little frustrated, but he should be really pleased with his team. They've kicked six goals to Port's four in this third quarter and looked every bit the side that we thought could challenge this year. Goldstein over the back. Cunnington did well, like a bulldozer he was. Just went straight over the top of White. Ball comes back towards the interchange area and we'll throw it in again. 3:33 remains in the third quarter.
BT, the thing that would please Brad Scott the most is the efficiency. Six goals, one. Looking at that fend off from Ben Cunnington. Six goals, one from only nine inside 50s this quarter. So efficient going forward. Somehow they've just got to generate a few more.
The umpire, it was a clear free kick. Bastinek had hold of the arm. Boak, as Richard Lingy pointed out, has had a pretty quiet night. Play on's a cool. What can Boak do? He's going to try and take Bastinek on. He pirouettes back around and then has a runner in Hartlett. Normally a clever kick, and that one in the end, it might have been a little legging from Tarrant. Mason Woods handball. Cracker read it well. Oh, Cracker went flat out at Higgins. He did well. Stood his ground. Nahas. He's going to run away from me, but takes a bounce. Oh, Ryder gave chase. Brilliant effort from the ruckman. Oh, that's a big play. When you're 6 foot six and the old ruckman runs down a little man, Richo, that is a big moment.
Yeah, Kenny Hinckley would love that. I thought Ryder would. I thought Nahas was out.
Yeah, you can have a look on the scoreboard on the replay screen there, Robin, but the biggest man on the ground ran down the littlest man. That's the way it was. Here they go. They're not finished within this quarter yet. Two and a half remain. Broadbent went a long way. A brilliant off-the-boot smother here from a desperate diving weight. Kick around the corner. It's picked up again here towards the end. Petrie went without the footy. Jonas did well. Got on the end of it. Cunnington. Cunnington, quick little slipper. Had not much on. Now a chance for Hobbs. Dished off the handball to Hartlett. Hartlett goes long and deep, but not to the advantage of Port. And they will just get 30 seconds of rest here. Have a look at the chase down here. There's the bounce and there's Paddy. And perhaps Ebert helping there with the tackle as well.
So here's Ryder. Great to see a man of that size working hard at ground level. Been a good battle between Goldstein and Ryder. They'll go at it again here with a couple of minutes remaining in the third quarter, Richo.
Yeah, North will be desperate not to concede here now. Got a couple of numbers back behind the footy. Cannot let Port get a goal here.
Boak just starting to have a little influence on the game. Hartlett good enough to get around one. Back to Boak. Dangerous centering ball. Good luck sitting under that turret. Monfries did really well. It's still in the air. Monfries will kick that around the body. Will he guess Monfries? Just across the face.
Nearly a disaster there. Which is Robbie Tarrant. Did his best to get it through, but couldn't quite get contact. The ball stayed alive.
Oh,
it would have been a disaster.
Monfries is a dangerous player. Been a great acquisition for Port Adelaide, no question about it. Now Swallow, the skipper, sends it down to Big Drew. Both hands on it again and got the free as well. So a good opportunity here for the Roos. A minute 25. Down by 10. Three-quarter time approaching. Tarrant. Bastanac. Handball wide, so North coming here. Thompson, long ball to right. Got a big knock early in the game. Got another one there as he sends the ball forward bound. Big Benny Brown marks. He just does it so easily. Now the little poker inside 50. Thomas turned his man, brought Ben inside out. Went through another. Left foot snap at goal, misses. The turn inside out king is Lindsay Thomas. And a miss. 9-point margin, Port Adelaide's way.
They bring it back into play. West off. He's pushed hard into defence. Now Young. They've got some hard runners as always. Port Adelaide, but Pollock just almost lost his way there for a second. They get away with it. West off. Ferrito met him full chested. Picked up by Tarrant. He's been okay, Tarrant. To Cunnington. Time for the Kangaroos if they can get it moving. Jacobs. And now McDonald. The hard-running Gibson. Robbie Gray applies some pressure. Waits got caught behind. Oh, great courage. That was Mitchell. Harvey will pick it up. Harvey will have a shot at goal. And Harvey will kick it. Will he? No, he's missed.
Chicharra Waite did well then. He did well to force the ball to ground. She would have put my house on Boomer to kick that goal. Here we go. Waite was 2-on-1. They almost spoiled each other, the Port defenders there.
Big kick in this. Pittard inches it forward, knowing the situation. Pomps the short ball. Siren's going to sound. Unbelievable action. Football here in the third. Stay with us on the other side of the break. One of the most exciting games of the year to date. Port lead it by 8 points. Injuries galore in this game. Zeeble's gone to hospital, and that was him coming off there as well. There's been plenty of exciting goals from the guys that are really quick and fleet-footed. Goals everywhere. Port by 9 points at quarter time. Big Drew and the Kangas just steadied early in the second quarter. Bastanac, Brown, Gibson all getting involved on the scoreboard, and an unlikely one in Tarrant as well. It has had its little controversial moments in the game, was it? Wasn't it? In the end, it wasn't, because it was touched by Bastanac there as well. Matty White almost ran his hamstring off the bone here as he banged it through for another, and it's been a frustrating night for Brad Scott and his staff in the box. They trail at the moment North by just 8 points in this game.
Attention, please. Watch movie after movie, episode after episode of the world's most popular shows. Get more choice. Go to presto.com.au for a free 30-day trial.
Yeah, get involved in Presto. You'd be mad not to. 30-day free trial. Sign up now. You can see Cameron Ling down there, and he has Matthew Nix with him.
Well, Nixie, in that quarter, North Melbourne, they were just able to score, weren't they? 6-3 from their 11 inside 50s. You were talking to the defenders. How do you stop that?
Yeah, well, look, we've got to get it done inside, unfortunately. Against a good running, ball-using side like North Melbourne, if we're not going to win the combo, we're not going to get the game done.
It has been a fast-paced game. What did you sense at three-quarter time there? The guys have got the legs?
Yeah, I think we've got the legs. I think they're just disappointed in that last quarter. They let themselves down, so they'll be keen to fight back in this last.
Appreciate your time, mate. Thanks.
All the best.
Cameron Ling down there with Matty Nix, and we're ready for a cracking last quarter of footy here. It has been seesawing all night. The pressure's been extraordinary. The running's been great, and the goals have been intriguing. That man there, Ben Brown, may well hold the key as he admires his own good looks on the big scoreboard here. We're ready to go. Goldstein, Paddy Ryder.
Port have put Robbie Gray to full forward and cleared the 50 out BT. That's a good move.
And who's his opponent, Richo?
Spud Ferrito.
Okay. Try and turn him inside out. He gets an opportunity, but not before before North and Higgins go forward. Up went Petrie, did well to reel it back in there. Trengover's there. Nahas got him too high. A little careless, and he was frustrated with himself. He plays on immediately and lessens the angle magnificently to the left-footed Wood. He is a sensational kick, as we've said tonight. He's a left-footed ass.
Yeah, they really rate his ability with the left foot, Mason Wood. This distance won't be an issue here. I like his chances.
So when he comes, right behind it, and that looks very, very impressive.
Yeah, what a great kick. He's been pretty good tonight. Mason Wood, 16 disposals. What a great start to the last quarter. The centre clearances are becoming pretty crucial as this game wears on. Port have been on top for most of the night, but North starting to come back in that way just a little bit.
You remember the corresponding game last year, the Kangaroos in round three here at Adelaide Stadium. They won by 7 points and went down to the wire. We've had the power lead at every break. We're back within 2 points now. And get the feeling we are set for an almighty finish to this one. Ryder brilliantly done to Boak. They get a long driving centre clearance in the goal square. Robbie Gray, the big body of Ferrito, clever enough. Back to Boak. He followed up his work nicely. Amble out to Ebert. Game number 150. Wobbling high. Helicopter style ball. Hard to mark. Kangaroos defenders get in each other's way. Ben Jacobs slides in. And probably not a bad result in the end for North defence.
You can just tell it's absolutely full-on desperation now. Donlan throws it up. Goldstein ripped it down magnificently to Swallow. Swallow with a kick under pressure. It's going to come back. Prengove, long handball wide to Hartlett. Tried to sell a little bit of foot candy, didn't Swallow it at all. Now Wingard and Swallow go at it.
A lot of numbers inside 50 here, as you'd expect, and it's going to be really tough for either team to get a nice, clean clearance out of this one.
Well, Port Adelaide have got a wall up made of four players onto North Melbourne's one at the moment, so if they do win at North, it ain't going to really help them. And here's one of those four, and there's another one, and he can go back to another one, and there's another one in the middle. That probably adds up to five. But it was a significant wall, let's say that. But little acts like that help you break the opportunity. Thompson had the ball knocked away. Atlee's got to go in and get it, and he does it nicely. Cunnington took too long, he's gone. That's a Brad Ebert special. And he'll line up directly in front as a result. And not without just a little chat in the ear either, Brad Ebert.
Take it, thanks.
Yeah, what a great tackle. Perfect tackle.
Go in, short.
Game 150 tonight, Ebert with a big goal here to give Port an 8-point lead early in the last, and he nails it.
Great response.
So the three goals to Brad Ebert, 20 possession game, big 150th night for him. He'd love to cap it off with a win here in the final quarter. Ryder. Goldstein got over the top. Young was pushed off it by Cunnington. Able to hack it forward. The clearances have been important, but the setup was impressive. And Jonas had that one covered. That's a dangerous ball into the corridor. Ebert, as we said, kicked his third goal. The last one of the game. He goes out wide, finds a teammate out wide. And Pinata, Tolly Wines down there, Lingy, having a bit of a drama at the moment.
Yeah, just getting his wrist checked out. He came off very sore and he ran straight to the bench, so he knew something was wrong. I'll keep an eye on it for you guys.
Good work, Lingy. Oh, Trengove's kick. It gave an opportunity to Jacobs. What can Petrie do? Trengove's got a problem now. What can Nahas, if he can pick it up, he'll get around his tackle without the footy, was he? Play on's the call. Jonas got it to his mate Hobbs, took his eye off it. Brown puts a little bit of pressure on. Oh, well done, Lindsay Thomas.
spills back to Jonas. He just wants it out of there, but it's going to come back pretty quickly. Gibson's had a big night.
There's some great forward pressure from both teams here in this last quarter.
Gibson to Brown. You think Brown's probably just out of range, but nothing that surprises you with this young man. He puts it into that hot spot. Petrie didn't know about it. He went up, had a couple of bites, knocked away by Pittard. Third grab, will it be paid? Umpire said no. Nice smother by Boak off the boot. Just the one-hand expert there was Jared Waite. Now White just wants the boundary line. That'll do him. It didn't quite get there with the help, but it does now. And this is that wrist incident. We think it happened just there. You can see. That's why he's on the bench. By the way, matches against Hawthorn and Adelaide in the next 2 weeks, Port Adelaide. It is crucial for them to get a win. Otherwise, it'll be 0-3 start, and they'll be facing the Hawks and Adelaide. Here's Boak. Six minutes played. 8-point lead, Port. Still plenty of coaching left in this game. Goldstein tapped down Pollack, confronted by Swallow. Mitchell confronted by a couple. Bastanac centering ball. It's a two-on-one there. He did well, Homps. Held Waite out of it.
Oh, Boak's on through the middle of the ground here.
He may have tested the umpire, and that's where it goes. Retro to Westhoff and Boak. Now on to Boak. He can kick it in front of Jay Schultz. He's got Thompson on the run. And a diving lunge by Schultz.
Great transition footy. He's in trouble, isn't he?
Yeah. We won't be seeing him tonight. Is that the red vest he's got on there? Yeah.
That is, BT. You're spot on. They've given him the red vest, so that doesn't look good for Ollie Wines. So it'll be the debutant, Brendan Archie, who's going to get his chance, the 21-year-old from South Fremantle. Great transition, though, by Port Adelaide. Fast ball movement sets up this shot at goal for Jay Schultz.
It's looking like a broken wrist to me.
He's in real pain.
Yeah, he is, isn't he? Schultz has got three. He is a very straight kick of the footy normally. Got a little close to the man on the mark there. Bends back. It's good. It's there. Schultz has got four. They lead it by 14.
Four goals to Jay Schultz. Little celebration. He liked it. There's the other story. Ollie Wines cradling a wrist. Doesn't look as though that is going to be a positive story at all for that young man. Boomer Harvey, they need to respond here. The Kangaroos have got to get this clearance. It was Bastanac to Cunnington, back to Attlee. Mason Wood took on the tackler. And now McDonald with the non-preferred right. Kane Turner gets up. Nice little step. He got around Wingard. Well, it's a hard footy for Attlee. Wrapped up by Westhoff. Boak. This is classic Port Adelaide on the rebound. Look at the runners. Crackers out. He's got Wingard. Crackers says, I'll kick it. I'll do it myself. And he misses. So, disappointing result.
Can North get some fast footy going from this kick in? Not a lot for Ferrito there.
I mean, the handball was on to Wingard, but I thought Cracker had
probably should have kicked it, shouldn't he?
Yeah, he had the right idea in going on with it. It was no means selfish, that is for sure. Here is an opportunity for McDonald. Archie's into the game for Port, the absence of Wines, who looks like he's got a bad wrist problem. Now around the corner, here's Cunnington, gets the ball at half foot, could have gone over the top to Gibson, but that was even better, and Lindsay Thomas stands. Thought about the play on, but go back, because you are the man, and Thomas needs to drill it from 30 in front.
See, both teams have been able to get some good transition there. North from a kick in. How does Lindsay Thomas get on his own inside 50 like that? Bit of confusion, obviously, out on the ground for that to occur.
15 goals.
Two goals last week for Thomas. Has one here tonight. Lines up this one to bring it back to single figures. The margin. Thomas. Good kick. Pressure kick. North Melbourne back within nine.
Well, look at the face of Ken Hinckley. He's just got that look of how much this game means. Likewise, Brad Scott. We're back in the centre. Clearances have been an enormous part, as they are most weeks. Ryder, Goldstein, Cunningham trying to muscle his way through. Harvey's had an impact, went down low, Boak getting involved to Gray. So the big names combine. They get it out to Pollack on his favoured left. Cracker down there. Schultz is on top of his man at the moment. He's just able to get some separation. And this is, well, within range, you'd think, for Jay Schultz.
Yeah, he's just been able to find space tonight. Sydney was so good at blocking it up last night. He's enjoying having some grass to lead into.
Tough kick. He's got to aim it outside left post, but he doesn't even go for it.
He doesn't have a crack. He does the team thing. He centres it. Young's going to try and burst his way through. Good tackle from Goldstein, the big boy. Young farmed a little one out. Got it back to the first game of the debutant, Archie. He got wrapped up. What a game to make your debut in.
What a moment to make your debut in.
Ooh, Brendan Archie couldn't get a game in the Sandful at times last year. Now he finds himself right out under the pressure.
He's right in the middle of this furnace at the moment, Archie. Let's see how he performs. Monfries to Archie. Ball was smothered. So North Melbourne in the hunt. Brown's got it all to do with Alapati. Carlisle did well to bring it to ground. Carlisle with a little knockdown of Pittard. Didn't bounce. Well done, Alapati. Little kick inside. Cut off. Port desperate. Even. North Melbore equal to the task. Trying to bore a hole through that was Gibson. White's holding. Umpire says we'll ball it up. Port by nine. Lots of time left. An exciting game of footy.
Goldstein looking right. Got right up over the top. This is an awkward bouncing footy. Hard to defend off. And Schultz used the body well on Thompson. Ben Jacobs handball back. In comes Monfries. White circling. They want holding the footy.
Gee, Robbie Gray at that last stoppage was on his own and he got the clearance. Got to man him up around this one here. He's so dangerous around these stoppages in the Port 50.
30 metres from Port's goal here, this stoppage, as Richo has described. Right of there, knocked down. Wingard was lurking out the back. Boak was inside as usual. Here's Broadbent. Might be within his range. He's a very good kick of the footy. Not one player is leading, which is always a bit of a giveaway.
Make the journey from here, Broadbent. Yep. No problems at all. He's a sensational kick of the footy.
So man on the mark's at 48, so he's going to have to kick at 53. There's the task ahead. Big kick. Broadbent steps. It's online. It's all about the distance. And he's got that as well. 15-point Port lead.
He gave that everything. It was a high ball, but he knew it was home.
The drop was nice, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Really nice drop.
Westhoff in the ruck. Goldstein tried to flick it out the back. Here's the first game for Archie. Let it go for Gray. Gray got tackled in correct disposal. Maybe looked like E, but good effort from Cunnington. The second one's been paid. The Kangaroo fans like it. They've got to get it moving quickly here. Cunnington. Releasing handball. This is Benny Jacobs back there. One-on-one. Petrie. Trengove.
Yeah, not many complaints there from Trengove.
Let's get a good look at it, Richo. A couple of these have gone the other way at the other end. We've seen Jay Schultz on the receiving end of a couple. Maybe over the shoulder late. So the big dish, Drew Petrie.
I think it was for the holding of the arm, I reckon, Das.
Big moment for the Kangaroos veteran. He makes no mistake, Petrie. We're back to a margin of just 9 points.
Nine-point ball game. Port Adelaide. I won't say they're in control, but they're in front. Three goals apiece here in this final quarter. Goldstein with a ripping knock out of the middle. The run by Cunnington. Tried the sneaky. Swallow gets a look. Kick slightly offline. Under pressure. 10 minutes precisely remain. And the margin is just 8 points, Das.
And they've got man, yeah. Man on the defence here, Richo, on the kick-in, which is normally advantage. The kick-in team, and that's exactly what happened there. Pittard was able to get through for Lindsay Thomas. Then he tried to take Thomas on. He picked his pocket, Lindsay. Oh, Pittard's second ever tackle was enormous.
Gee, there's been some great tackling tonight.
Jasper Pittard, it was a great response. He mucked up the first one. Now Polak is going to take him on again. Can he get past Higgins? And Lapati's having a run through the middle of the ground. It'll favour Robbie Tarrant. Probably should have marked it. Stepping up there, McDonald back to Benny Jacobs, and Jacobs clearing kick to the one-on-one.
Got a bit of a mini wall out there, a box. Four Port Adelaide players converged on one North, but they've done extremely well here, North Melbourne. Little handball, Higgins, he was looking for the give and go off Harvey. Now he's got to give it and he won't be able to go. Jacobs, beautiful vision out the side there. Now Ferrito runs through centre-half back. He's going to have to carry the ball. He does to centre-half. Nahas dropped the mark he probably should have taken. Drew cleared the path for him. Broadbent wrapped him up in a double chicken wing, double bone tackle. It was a beauty. 9 minutes remain.
Look at this here. Drew Petrie coming out in the lead. Nahas going back. Drew, he probably had to hold up on his lead there and call Nahas in, which he probably did do.
There's some big moments to be had in this game. Plenty of time. Still just under 9 minutes remaining. We're going to get a secondary ball up here on the edge of 50. Look at the Port Adelaide players. They get back in number around the contest. A lot of instruction going on out there. Look for Lindsay Thomas. Swallow gets a run up at it. He had his mark and then found the footy to Higgins, who's kicked a lot of goals in his short career at the Kangaroos so far. That one across the face. Higgins couldn't get it online. They do get another opportunity. Build some pressure.
It's a good spot to defend from here too, Darcy. Even if Port Adelaide do win it, they'll probably kick it back to that North Melbourne wall. They might get another re-entry.
Goldstein, the double-handed flick over the back. Gray there, little handball off. Here they go, Jonas to Hartlett. Hartlett, a high ball, be very nearly out of bounds. Westhoff helped him. So just a chance here for the players to grab their breath. See the clearances here, 10-5 in this fourth quarter, North Melbourne's way. Crowd 22,586 here tonight. Should be more given the quality of this contest and the North Melbourne expectations. We are set for a cracking finish. Goldstein, swallowed through traffic. Ebert had him covered. Very quick hands out the back. Young involved now. Hartlett on the march they go. There's an opportunity at half. Ford went hard at it. McDonald didn't skirt the issue. Confronted by Cracker. Now they've got some wheels on the outside. It's the veteran Harvey. Little handball over the top. He wanted it back. Nahas chipping ball. Here's Waite. Long way from home. Dragging handball to right. He can go all the way here right. Gets to 50. Didn't really have a crack at it. Just wanted to get it to Thomas. He's been infringed by Mitchell. Thomas has got a free at the top of the square.
Yeah, Mitchell just panicked then. It was a great kick by White over the top to Lindsay Thomas. Mitchell was caught out of position badly and he just panicked and impeded his run at the footy. Big kick now for Lindsay Thomas. He's kicked well all night. He's got to nail this one.
Thomas for his third goal to get the margin back to two. Brad Scott liked what he saw there. Surely he kicks this. His new way has stood up to pressure, and it does just that. They're within 2 points, North Melbourne. They've kicked three of the last four goals. Thomas has three.
Lindsay Thomas has got his third goal. What about this play, Richo, from Luke McDonald? They were careering forward at halfback, and only his 26th game, Luke McDonald, he went back, he committed his body. It was a massive moment. If the Kangaroos are to get up, have a look at that. He had Cracker bearing down. The build-up to that, it was a 40-metre run-in. He wins a 50-50 ball. They go down the other end and score a goal. Massive play, young Luke McDonald.
Yeah, absolutely outstanding. And there's been some huge wins in one-on-ones by both teams tonight. It's been a committed game. We've seen a lot of carnage down on the bench, BT.
Yeah, I've been happy to get Paddy Ryder back on the ground and Goldstein. They renew hostilities. Free kick's been picked out.
One-on-ones in each forward 50 now. The loose man's been given up by both sides at that bounce.
So Ryan Bastanac, he was dropped after round one. Feel like it's a big night for him. No Nick Dalsado out for a long period of time. Ben Brown gives a contest. Look at them smashing. Mason Wood was there. Brown tried to pick it up at ground level. Lindsay Thomas come through. He's kicked three. Can he make it four? Lindsay Thomas can. Kangaroos hit the front. What a goal for Lindsay Thomas. He picked it up cleanly. North Melbourne fans go berserk. And he has done a fantastic, fantastic bit of play there, Richo.
Yeah, have a look at this. Big contest. Thomas comes through, one hand, taps it out in front. Brilliant stuff. That's what he's there for. He's a small forward. You've got to get the job done at ground level, and that's what he's done.
He's got four. The crowd rise in voice here at Etihad Stadium. They are in front, the Roos, by 4 points. Still lots of time. 7 minutes. Ryder with a knockdown. Quick little clearance out the middle here. Goes Porchway to their attacking 50. Ran over the top of their RG. Frito went back and got it. Couldn't quite reel it in, Gibson, but Wright's got some wheels. Took a bounce on the wing. Here he goes with his non-preferred. Petrie was there. Did well, Westhoff. Third man up in the contest to help Alapati Carlisle. And it was well done. North have got it at their end. Boundary throw in. They have kicked four of the last five and got the last three in a row. And they lead by just four. Swallow to Gibson. Very tight on the boundary.
Well, they've got it done out of the centre tonight in this last quarter. 6-3. The centre clearances up until that point. Port have had the advantage all night, but in this crucial last quarter, North are getting first use.
Huge 6.5 minutes coming up to finish this game. Port Adelaide yet to register a win. That'll be a free kick going the Kangaroos' way. He's been really big in a couple of massive moments, has McDonald. Normally a good left foot kick, decides to drive it long. Where are the big boys? Brown's down there. Out the back, Mason Wood's going to pick it up. Get on his left foot, which way will it bounce? Just to the near side. Margin out to 5 points.
Port would love a quick play here, but the ball's been held up. North have got them covered. Can Port find an outlet?
Well, with 6 minutes to go, it's obvious that they've got to do something. Not necessarily quickly. They've still got composure as their main item up their sleeve, and they need to have that here. Monfries from the wing. Chips inside. Gee, it's a risky kick, but it's a great kick.
Don't you love that? Tight game last quarter, and they still play bold footy, yeah, AT.
Absolutely.
But you, North Melbourne, have defended well at the moment. They've allowed the switch, though, and if Port Adelaide can get the overlap, they'll be right now.
Well, it's in the hands of Broadbent now. Here's the kick to Mitchell. It's really precise. Mitchell marks out of range. Wants someone to come at him. Boak does. He ignores that. There's the pitcher. You can see it all. High ball. Shoots the danger. Ryder in front.
Great mark.
Ryder from 25 on the angle.
Big time for Paddy Ryder to stand up. They had nothing else here. They needed a contested mark. And he's made Goldstein defend. Gotta love that.
Schultz did well to get a body on Goldstein as well, which helped Ryder secure the footy. Big time kick here. This to put Port back in front. There is the very confronting task. Ryder steps to the plate. Big, big moment. Misses left. 4 point margin in favour of North. Lots of time. 4.5 minutes.
Now you got to love the play from Ryder. Pushing Goldstein to the goal square. He's a goal-kicking ruckman. Be disappointed with the finish, though. The Kangaroos through Benny Jacobs. Long, searching kick out to Waite. Hasn't been his night tonight. Alapati Carlisle picked it up off his toes. Got it moving forward. Getting back defensively, Gibson. Letting possession gather on the ground for most of tonight. He's up to 28. Swallow's got 30. So you can just feel the tension under the closed roof here at Etihad Stadium. Trengove taking a turn in the ruck. Well done, Robbie Gray. This is the first game of Archie. Clever play. He got it out to Young back in the side. Young will kick a goal and give the power the lead back. That's exactly what he does. Power half back in front. They lead it by 2 points.
Massive, massive clearance by Robbie Gray again. And if we get a look at it, he was able to get a run on it. He shouldn't be allowed that. He had to be bodied up there, Robbie Gray. He was allowed to run forward towards the goals without any hindrance on him. And it was his clearance. Look at this. No body on Robbie Gray.
And what about the combination? There is a man on debut, Archie. This man's back in the side, Young. They made changes and they are rewarded. What a contest this is.
Port by 2 points, down to 4 minutes.
They've stacked their back line now. Lingy down there, Port Adelaide.
They certainly have. They've got some numbers back. Let's see how North Melbourne handle it. They just need to keep playing the way they've been doing, but that's costly. Free kick from the centre bounce. Port Adelaide will try and control the ball from here. North have got to make them kick long to a contest.
A long time to be doing that, isn't it? 4 minutes.
Yeah, but if they can take a minute or so off the clock here, it makes it very difficult. But you're right, they're going to get an opportunity, North Melbourne, to win it back.
Trengove didn't want to test himself inside, went down the line as he should, played within his capabilities. An opportunity here now, Schultz is lurking, well done out the back door. Higgins did the hard work. Wingard knocked it down magnificently to Archie, tumbled it inside 50, here they go. McDonald under extreme pressure, so is Jacobs, they all are. Back to McDonald, he got absolutely flattened, McDonald. It's a down the field three.
Got one-on-one sport of the footy, North got to get it moving quick here.
3.25 minutes, Port by two. Brown goes searching for Wade. Wade elevates over the top. And now Port will get possession. They need a mark here if they can for them to hold it up. Westhoff's hurt his knee in that contest, and Brown's got it. I tell you what, Wade shouldn't be trying to help Westhoff off. He should be getting forward to win the footy. What's he doing? Jacobs in half back.
Gets it to Ferrito. They're going to try and overlap this one through the corridor. Atlee's got speed. Hands it over the top. This is the young boy Kane Turner looking for Petrie. No free kick. The numbers back there. Ryder sweeping handball and a bit of composure. Pollack took Thomas on. Now a chance for Swallow. Back to Pollack. They're being forced backwards. Pittard's handball. Set a bit of a task to Hartlett. A short one is on. And Kane Mitchell, another of the inclusions tonight. He is just going to hang on to it to just over 2 minutes. Remaining kicks into the man on the mark. Which way will it bounce? Favourably for Broadbent. They keep it in their forward half of the ground, the Kangaroos.
Gee, both these teams are out on their feet right now. Players on the bench are tired. Players out on the ground are tired. It's whoever can hold on the longest. It's been a fast-paced game. Everyone is tired.
Ball almost in neutral territory on the wing. Ferrito just muscles it inside 50 for the Roos. Waits there. Thomas was lurking dangerously around the front. Spills to Wood on his left foot. Missed the lock. Out of bounds. So this is a chance. North need to man up really quickly here.
Port need to get a switch here, BT. They don't want to go down the line. They want to try and keep possession.
Look at the kick inside. It's gutsy.
Great kick.
Ebert marks half back. There's no need for them to go fast if they don't wish. Monfrey's wanting the ball right out this side of the ground. You can almost see him.
North have got to come down and get one-on-one because they've got loose players behind the footy. They can hold on to it now, Port.
Port by 2 points, a minute 43. It's all or nothing here right now. How good are Port at retaining the footy? They would have practiced this in the pre-season with only minutes left in the game to try and milk the clock. Here's Pollack, real handball to himself, hoping for the boundary line, and Wingard just steadies it over, so they've worked it.
Did a half forward.
Time for a hero here. Kangaroos, they've got to score. They'll flick it out the back. Goldstein and Ryder. We've seen them head-to-head all night. Goldstein takes front position. Ryder gets in front. Oh, Robbie Gray's been magnificent. He wins the clearance. Hacks it forward. This will suit Port. They get back. McDonald's had some big plays. He's the first one back. They've got to keep it in. Schultz tries to corral the footy. Jacobs comes in. Now he gets it moving to Boak. Can the skipper get it boot to ball? To Monfries, chipping footy. Ah, big play. Finds Mitchell. Brad Scott can't believe it. And now a lot rests on this man's shoulders, Kane Mitchell. 24th game of AFL football. Never had a bigger moment.
Absolutely. If he kicks a point, North Melbourne will have possession and a chance to go coast to coast to win the game. If he kicks it, Port will win the game.
Young boy from Western Australia. He's a passionate origami expert, apparently. This is his biggest kick of his life. And Kane Mitchell kicks it. The power leader by 8 points. We've got 26 seconds. That might be the game right there.
Great kick under extreme pressure. But once again, it was a Robbie Gray clearance on the outer front half-forward flank, which got the ball inside 50, which gave them this opportunity.
Pressure kick.
Great drop.
A bit of a straight drop, Bristol. You like that?
Nice.
Now they've got to score twice in 30 seconds. Well, big task.
It's got to be pretty nearly perfect footy from here for North. Bang out of the middle, inside 50, mark goal, stop clock, and go back and then hope for a prayer at the end. Port Adelaide may have done enough. 8 points up with half a minute remaining. Have North got one last blast in them?
Goldstein over the back to Swallow. Here they go. Couldn't get it clear. Great tackle by Gray. He realised the significance of that tackle. And have a look at the Port Adelaide numbers back here. Ball up in the middle. Big punch by Wright. They work it forward. Mitch, look at Ferrito. He's tackling a couple of them. I reckon the Port players were tackling each other as well. And Port are going to win their first game of the year here. Port are going to win. A lot of pressure. They play Hawthorn next week. Goldstein out the back, but it's all over. 5 seconds and counting here. Thompson goes long with the Torp. Port have won in an absolute thriller over North Melbourne by 8 points.
Captain, 150-game player, Brad Ebert. It was just a sensational game of footy, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. It was fast-paced, high tempo. We know it was going to be like that, but, I thought the game was really won or lost. We talked about before the game, the combo, you know, the stuff inside, the hard ball gets, the contested ball, the tackles. So I really felt like we stood up there. We might not have won the actual contest itself like that, but it was good to be able to get away with the win, you know.
Was everyone as exhausted as we thought you guys were? It was just such a fast game.
Yeah, it was. And that's where probably we've got to be able to take the heat out of it sometimes and just, you know, settle it down a little bit. But I thought we did that pretty well in the end. And it was great for Kane Mitchell to top it off with a goal at the end just to make sure that we sealed it.
It was a pretty ice-cold kick, wasn't it? A tough set shot, but nailed it.
Danger. Mitchell, he was cool under pressure, that's for sure. So it was good.
Oh, well done tonight, mate. Congratulations on the 150 game as well. Great effort.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, Brad Ebert, he was very, very impressive tonight along with his teammates here, Darce and Richo. It's a big win for Port. They go down tonight, they confront Hawthorn and then Adelaide over the next 2 weeks. They've done well.
Yeah, there was a lot riding on that result tonight for the Power. We know the expectation on that group of boys leading into this season. And likewise, the Kangaroos, Ken Hickney, a little fist pump down there. They're going to be around the mark, both these sides, and that hurts, doesn't it?
Yeah, Port Adelaide got the game that they would have liked tonight. They haven't got that in the first 2 weeks. The fast game as we go back down to Lingy.
It was a fast-paced game, and one bloke who did an amazing job, especially in that last quarter, Robbie Gray. It was an incredible last quarter, wasn't it? The way they came at you guys, but you were able to settle, must have made you really happy.
Yeah, no doubt. You know, we had a nice lead in that second half there, but they really come home hard. We knew they were there on quality side, so you know, we had to get back to doing the basics and, you know, try and win the ball a bit around stoppage and stand up defensively, and I thought we were able to do that.
Speaking of those last few stoppages, you had a big influence. Did you really grit the teeth and say, right, I need to win these clearances to get the ball forward?
Yeah, when we were down, I think we rolled the dice a little bit there and, you know, try and get the ball forward to give ourselves an opportunity to score. So, you know, it came off this time, but it doesn't always come off like that.
And there were plenty of goal-kicking options tonight, wasn't there? Obviously, Jay Schultz kicking 4, Brad Ebert 3 as well, but plenty of blokes getting on the score sheet.
Yeah, it's probably where we struggled the last couple of weeks. We had plenty of entries, but, you know, haven't been out getting the scoreboard. So we had a good mix tonight, which was really good, and, you know, we've got a lot of dangerous players down there, so it was good for us.
Well, we loved the game, mate. I'm sure you did as well. Well done. Great stuff.
Better when you win, mate.
Didn't look like he'd raised a sweat there, Robbie Gray. He had 5 clearances in that last quarter. He was very significant, as Liggy said, and the shots of Ollie Wines looking like he's heading off to hospital for an X-ray there, Darce, down in the room.
Yeah, that will be the tragedy out of this game. We know that we've also got Jack Zeeble in hospitals getting some scans on his chest area, so wish both those men well. Ollie Wines has had almost the perfect start to his career in 50 games, but I felt like it was their big players. It was Robbie Gray and Boak, when they needed them in the last quarter, stood up big time, Richo.
Absolutely. Travis Boak, his last 30 minutes was by far his best 30 minutes in this game, and let's hope he's okay. Ollie Wines going off for an X-ray, but the way he was holding
his arm suggests there may be a break there, BT.
Yeah, it always, when you have a broken wrist and a broken arm, it feels a bit loose and you feel like you need to cradle it. That's why he would have been cradling it. I would say odds on, that's trouble for Ollie Wines.
Yeah.
I guess the only thing, he's not on the green stick, is he?
No, he's not.
Tough, hard young man, country Victoria, and I think he would have given him the green stick and he would have said, not required. I'll just suck it up, Ollie Wines.
Here they come. They're really going to enjoy this. Their first win of the year. A big-time win away from home. Etihad Stadium. They don't necessarily play all that well at this ground. And they have mustered up a ripper here.
Good. Kenny's pretty happy. Getting around the boys. Is they're about to rip into the song.
Jubilant scenes there inside the power rooms. The first game of Brendan Archie, and they are celebrating. And a bit of relief there for Ken Hinckley, the coach. Don't go anywhere. We have got an enormous amount coming up in the post-game show. A big night for the Tigers. We'll be all over that, but full of emotion tonight. It was Port Adelaide with their first win for season 2015.